Mountain Event Center here in Rock Hill, South Carolina for the 2021 ACL World Championships brought to you by Johnsonville. No doubt the biggest week of the year in the sport of cornhole, and alongside Trey Ryder, I'm Jeff McCarriger. So excited and happy to be here. And Trey, this is just an incredible week. Over 1,200 players from, 44 states, even two from Canada down here competing. Obviously, you got all the pros here competing to be a world champion. There's Greg Geary. And we are down to the bracket finals tonight. Trey, you and I were just talking about it, but it's worth noting again. I mean, this starts with four brackets, 64 players in each, and now we're down to the bracket finals. So just to get here is really an amazing feat.
Yeah, it really is. I mean, the best players in the world, the toughest talent that this sport has ever seen, and now they're throwing it down for a chance to get to that ESPN broadcast on Saturday at 1 p.m. Eastern for that pro singles playoff, and a chance to follow in the footsteps of Jamie Graham in 2020 as a world champion.
And speaking of Jamie Graham, it's worth noting right off the top, he is the defending world champion, but we will have a new world champion because he was upset earlier today. So here we go, underway now from Rock Hill. There's a good look at Jordan Power here on the near side. Great young player. And then Greg Geary. And Greg looking for his first win of 2021 after having an incredible 2020. And what a way to wrap up the season. Greg Geary could pull this off.
Yeah, this is our bracket final. Four brackets, bracket A, bracket B, bracket C, and bracket D. So we are going to show you right here the loser's bracket final, or the elimination bracket final of bracket B. And what that means is both of these players have already suffered one loss. Obviously, if you lose this game, you're eliminated. The winner of this game will go on to play Trey Birchfield in the finale of Bracket B immediately following this game.
Really 2-0 lead here for Jordan Power as Greg Geary's bag just would not come back in. It looked like it was going to maybe try and kind of nudge its way back in and fall in, but it did not. So Power now with the honors and puts the first one in. Jordan Power's been a good young player from Flat Rock, Michigan. Does have a win on the season on the double side, on the pro shootout side in Memphis.
Yes, he won alongside Dave Sutton. They will be in that pro shootout championship on September 18th. It's a breakout win for him in his rookie season.
Not only is it his rookie season, he's only been playing the sport for a little over 2 years, about 2.5 years now.
Yeah, and he is stroking right now. Absolutely stroking.
Back-to-back four baggers, and now a 4-0 lead here for Jordan Power.
Give Jordan two more, make it 4-0.
Now Jordan has really taken the sport seriously. He's actually a student at Eastern Michigan, and he works, but still finds time to practice 5 to 7 days a week. And I mean, he's really taken it to a different level of practice, Trey, because, I mean, not only does he just sit there and throw over and over, but he told us before that he'll actually set up situations on the board. So he'll put different bags at different spots just to try and see how he can work it.
That's honestly the best way to practice. You have to simulate some level of situation when you're playing. Throwing bag after bag after bag in the hole, don't get me wrong, that is great for muscle memory, but the problem is it doesn't establish any type of game situation for yourself.
Yeah.
The two things you have to simulate when you're trying to practice alone is you have to simulate, one, different game situations, and two, you have to find a way to simulate game pressure. Some players do it in a variety of different ways. Noah Wooten, as you said many times, puts his boards on a dock and says he can't throw it off the back because it'll go into the water. Other players, you know, I've heard some players almost make decisions around the house or what they're going to do for the day based on how they perform against some level of fake opponent. So, I mean, there's a variety of different ways to simulate game pressure, but that's really what you have to do in order to be successful.
Jordan's bag trampolines off the back. This will snap a stretch of 12 straight to start the match for Jordan Power. And trying to push those in, able to get one to fall. And now last bag coming up here for Greg. At least some chance for points here, right? Because Jordan's was off the back.
Exactly.
So see if Greg can get on the board. He does. Nice push shot there to collect two.
Yeah,
So again, Greg Geary, back in 2020 in Phoenix, I mean, he just owned the desert. He was the only one last year during the pro shootout who double dipped, winning both on the singles and double side. And as you mentioned, Trey, he was also part of the team of the year with Jimmy McGuffin, but no wins here yet in 2021.
Four to zero by Jordan Power, and he's just been such a great player, especially with those blocks right there all season long. Now, that's the Greg Geary that we saw in 2020, was just the ability to hit relentless air mails, and now we get an opportunity for Greg Geary to get on the board here in a big way.
He's got three in, looking for a four bagger here. Just going for a slide shot up the middle, and he hits it and does so gingerly without taking Jordan's bag in. So four bagger for Greg Geary. And just like that, we got a lead change. 5-4. Geary on top. But Greg is no stranger here to the TV scene. He's been on national TV, I think he told me, up to 10 or 11 times now. He's got two right there on the right side. Jordan was trying to stay skinny, like you say, Trey, but just couldn't quite sneak around those bags.
Now the question will be, will Greg Geary go with an airmail or a push up the center? He's going airmail.
God,
that was super aggressive. And now Power can
finish. Come on.
Finish, and he does. You heard him talking to himself.
Boy, that was almost one of those situations, Trey, where that was almost worst case scenario, because not only did he not hit the airmail, but he also took the one bag in that was kind of in the way of Jordan. So allowed Jordan just to go right up the middle and take them both in. That one slides a little bit, missing left. See if that opens up a door again here for Geary. 8-5 Jordan. Again, here in the national events, the World Championships, we are back to traditional scoring. Oh, nice shot. So first one to 21 are over. No round limitations. It's funny that the debate rages on, doesn't it? It's almost like in baseball, whether you like the DH or you don't like the DH, between round limits and cornhole and first one to 21.
Right.
Yeah.
I think it's fun to have both.
I think having both kind of is a way to balance out the sport in a way.
Yeah.
Because they both have their pros and cons, right? I mean, obviously, we love the play to 21 format because it allows for these big swings and big comebacks. But on the other side, a game could end 21-4 and be a complete blowout. Whereas something that's round limited has a better chance of always being close.
Right.
But in fairness, again, you can still have a game that ends 8-4, and you never feel like you get to the meat, the meat portion of the game. So it's just pros and cons on both sides.
Right. Well, what a rally here for Jordan Power. He has now scored 8 straight. Remember, Greg Geary just moments ago had a 5-4 lead. It was 4-0 Jordan, and Greg had that big round to take a 5-4 lead. Now 13-5 Power. I don't know if Geary can sneak in without taking Jordan's bag. Yeah, he can't do it. A chance here for Greg to snap this 8-0 run, and he does. A couple of points to make it 13-7.
13-7.
Well, we talk about a lot of these players being athletes in other sports. Jordan Power is an interesting story. I mean, he played baseball and basketball, but actually bowling was his best sport. Actually bowled in college. His best game is a 285.
Wow.
Yeah. I mean, he's legit. He's a really good bowler.
But, you know, it's just, even though two different sports, the mentality, he said, just so similar, right? It's, you're just up there by yourself.
Two more.
And that one's in. Good round for both players. Double four baggers, so the wash keeps it 13-7.
Now the question will become, you know, how can Greg Geary make this an airmail game?
Me?
Yeah. Right? Because right. I think Jordan Power has shown so far that bag for bag, he's going to lead it, right? Big pushes, he's going to lead it. Greg Geary's got to get a little bit creative, I think. I think he's got to find a way to make it an airmail game without making it a push game. And that's so different. It's so subtle, right? Because in a push game, I still think Jordan Power can win. But in an airmail game, I think Greg Geary has the advantage there. So it's going to be double blocking when Jordan Power comes up a little bit short. It may be forcing a deep block and Jordan Power not coming all the way through. But he's got to get a little bit creative, because I think Jordan Power is going to be tough to beat right now.
Yeah, and you're right as far as bag for bag goes, Trey. I mean, you're exactly right. I think Jordan's back up to 12 straight now. Had a four bagger to score a couple of points, and then now back-to-back four baggers for both players. It's interesting. On that last shot, on that first bag by Greg, he hit the front of the board almost like he was maybe trying to lay a block, and then just slid all the way up and in. Oh, good push by Jordan. What a shot. Right there. Is he trying to slow that one down, or is it just going all the way up the board?
No, I don't think he's trying to. I don't think he's necessarily trying to slow it down.
I pulled it. Oh, wow.
Wow. He'll take it. That's always a gift. Don't you like that? You think you miss it and it goes in?
Yeah, that never happens to me.
I thought I was coming up short. Yeah. Yeah,
13-7. I remember one of the first times I talked to Greg Geary, I asked him what he did for a living. Well, he actually used to work for UPS. UPS Healthcare, but then during COVID ended up switching jobs. I remember talking to one time, he said he was a lineman, and I instantly obviously thought he was talking about football.
Right.
I mean, you can tell he's huge, but he's actually a lineman, works for a telephone company, actually physically lays the lines. Big guy. Awesome guy to talk to.
Like we said, that he's also, last year had such a great year with Jimmy McGuffin. They finished as the 2020 team of the year, the number one overall team after the World Championships.
Again.
Well. Jordan again. thought he had pulled it. And again, it goes in. Wow, so Jordan stays. Well, both of them staying hot here.
That's when you know you're throwing well, when even when you're missing, you're right up the center.
All right, so Trey, you know, this gets to an interesting point of the game. So 13-7, both players just going bag for bag. We're up to what, three straight or four straight four baggers. At some point, do you get impatient and try to get clever, or do you just try and just keep the momentum right now? You know,
it's tough because you are throwing so well now if you're Greg Geary going bag for bag.
Yeah.
It's like, I don't know if I want to try that.
Right.
I think they're just going to try to wait each other out here and see who's the first to blink, because neither one of them have blinked here.
Wow.
I mean, what
another
is
one.
This?
Yet another double four-bagger wash.
I mean, just if I look at this right now, Jordan Power, his average round score right now, 11.08.
Oh, my gosh.
That's five straight double four-baggers and six straight four-baggers for Jordan Power. That's 24 in a row for him right now.
Little bit short, but he could still bring it back in. Now it's going to set up for an interesting shot here for Greg Geary. Kind of what you were talking about, Trey. Yeah, he's going to go for it. Oh, a little bit short. Takes Jordan's bag in, and Power with another four-bagger. Now 28 straight.
Jordan with another four-bagger. Give him two there. Make
28 straight.
Wow.
He's coming up on a record here, Jeff.
I was going to say, this is one of the longer streaks
we've seen.
I believe
31 is the record.
Was it Cody Henderson earlier this year?
Yeah.
There's another one. I thought for sure that was going to be the kiss of death. All we had to do was start talking about it.
What's number one rule in a perfect game?
Yep.
You don't talk about a perfect game?
Right. Never mention the no-hitter. So is Cody's 31 the record? Because this is to tie it right here.
Right here.
Goes right.
Oh,
see, I knew it would happen here at some point.
That is just evil, what we just did.
Yep.
That's our fault, Jeff.
Yep.
It's my fault.
Sorry,
it's not
Jordan.
Your fault. It's not. It's mine. It's 100% my fault. And Greg Geary.
So 31 of 32 for Jordan Power.
Well, hold on. Hold the phone for a second. Let's go look and see what. Greg threw a 10 the other round because Jordan got two. I was about to go look. Yeah, Greg, unfortunately, has only just thrown 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of 8 four-baggers, unfortunately. Only 7 of the last 8 rounds have been four-baggers, so it's a disappointing second half of this game for Greg Geary.
Yeah, a lot of room for improvement. disappointing match.
I mean, this is outrageous. Like I said, so Greg Geary. So Jordan Power has hit 38 of 40.
Wow. I knew he had gone 31 of 32, so he's only missed two this entire round. What a push.
And Greg Geary has hit 31 of 32.
Wow. Little bit right, and now Power looking to get back on track. He does. So, Trey, that's what, 42 of 44 now?
Give Jordan two more, make it 17.
It's a lot.
It was 38 out of 40, I think he said. So, 42 out of 44. What a stretch right now here for Jordan Power out of Eastern Michigan University. And another one right at the lip. It truly is amazing how far up the boards Gary's bag flies. I mean, he's literally hitting that kind of between the edge of the board and the ACL mark.
Almost every time it's like you kind of because it almost sometimes feels like he's going to hit a dead spot.
Yeah. And it just somehow slides its way all the way up. Oh, he helps out Jordan. And now Power again with a four bagger. And that one out of play here for Greg. So two more now for Jordan Power. And now he's closing in on a victory here. 19-9. I've got unofficially here 46 out of 48 for Jordan Power. And Jordan goes right through it. Oh, and now Jordan's got a chance to win it.
Wow.
Third one is in. The one in his hand can be the winner.
And now the best situation here is actually for Greg Geary. You want to be a block here. And the reason for that, and he tries to. You see he throws his hands up in the air. This is for the win.
Jordan Power, another four-bagger. This bag is not going to matter. Good airmail by Greg Geary, but not enough. Jordan Power on a roll, and he advances here in Rock Hill. What a performance.
What a performance is right. He was absolutely outrageous.
We'll get the official stats when we come back. I've got 50 out of 52 for Jordan Power as he wins it over Greg Geary.
Try Try Bush's Sweet Heat baked beans with that pop of jalapeno heat. And boom, your regular old Thursday night is a jalapeno night. Bush's makes any night beautiful.
And spicy.
At Johnsonville, we've often wondered, how can burgers and dogs be our national tradition when you can't even spell sausage without USA? Exercise your right to mix it up and throw on some Johnsonville sausage, because freedom is delicious. Your backyard deserves the best. For a limited time, buy Johnsonville sausage or Bush's baked beans for a chance to win a Pit Boss grill, professional cornhole boards, and sausage and beans for a year. Learn more at bestofthebackyard.com.
AllCornhole.com has the largest online selection of cornhole bags for players of all levels. Through years of research and development, AllCornhole.com has the perfect bags for even pro-level players. With over four unique series to choose from, including Game Changers, All Slides, Slide Rights, and Steadies, you'll be sure to find the right bags to dominate the competition. Whether you're looking for bags for family gatherings, competitive league night, or the pro circuit, go to AllCornhole.com to get the perfect boards and bags for you.
In this house, we believe anyone can play and anyone can win. Where others have dropped the ball, the American Cornhole League has stepped up to the plate. Carefully crafted and trusted by players everywhere, we've set the standard for cornhole equipment worldwide. Branded with ACL Pro, ACL Competitive, and ACL Recreation stamps, look for our seal of approval to know you're making the right choice. Play like a pro with officially licensed American Cornhole League boards and bags from approved manufacturers. Visit our website to find your new game day gear.
They say there's no such thing as a free lunch, but there is at DraftKings. You can compete for thousands in prizes in our free-to-play pools without spending a dime. Put your knowledge to the test by answering questions about specific games or events. The more you pick right, the better your shot to win and chow down on a cash casserole. Casserole. Download the DraftKings app now. Enter with the promo code Play Free for Thousands and make it rain.
Dustin Poirier wanted a better life, built it. Wanted respect, earned it. Wanted a title, won it. Decided to change the world, doing it. You know how my man keeps accomplishing everything he sets out to do? He believes that he can. Guaranteed Rate believes in your dreams. That's why we treat everyone like we treat our own family and work extra hard to get you the lowest low rate possible. Because if you believe, you will.
Those beautiful Bush's baked beans. The delicious center of picnic table gravity that keeps the whole great barbecue universe spinning. Bush's makes the cookout beautiful.
Welcome back inside the Rock Hill Sports and Event Center here in Rock Hill, South Carolina, just south of Charlotte. The ACL World Championships presented by Johnsonville, continuing live coverage. Thanks for joining us tonight with Trey Ryder and Jeff McCarriger, and there is Jordan Power. So we have the official stats. Jordan, in that win over Greg Geary, hit 66 of 72 bags for the entire match.
All right,
and 50 of his last 52.
Is that
final,
is that good?
Trey Birchfield.
I don't know if I've seen
a game
on a broadcast with you. I mean, we've seen some great performances, obviously, but 50 out of 52?
It's pretty darn good.
I know we've seen Samantha Finley a few times go off with 31 of 32, something like that. But 50 of 52?
That's a lot. That's a lot of consistent play.
Had 30 straight at one point, just missed that 31 in a row mark with the season that was set by Cody Henderson.
Now, what I am going to say is that I am blown away. This is going to shock a lot of people, but I am shocked to see Trey Birchfield on this stage. Reason why is he is less than 4 weeks out of having his appendix taken out. Okay, he woke up in the middle of the night one night in screaming pain, had to rush to the ER, had his appendix out. He is still in pain. I literally asked him an hour ago. He said, sometimes I sit here, I don't feel a thing, and then on some throws, it's, oh gosh.
Bites him a little bit?
It just bites him.
Yeah.
And so, for that, in a game that's so mental and something you have to be so mentally focused, I mean, no. People at home that are watching this saying, what? It's not a contact sport. Well, no, I'm not necessarily saying he's going to throw every bag off the board, but when you talk about a game that is a game of millimeters, if during one of those backswings something just hurts a little bit, yeah. is that enough to push a bag to the left and give up 2 points every 10 throws? I mean, if he's at 95% or 90% of what he normally is that enough to beat someone like Jordan Power, who just threw 50 of 52 bags in the hole?
Right.
Oh.
Ooh, too hard off the left side and off the board.
Now Trey Birchfield, an opportunity here, and he capitalizes. Jordan Power got to go in just to limit it to five. He does.
Big round for Trey Birchfield, the number two player in the world. There he is, just 17. I think he's still 17. I think he's going to be 18 later on this month.
Yeah, obviously a world championship here would solidify a number one ranking and a world championship win. That would match what Jamie Graham did last year. So Trey Birchfield is still in it. Damon Dennis has been eliminated. You will not see Damon Dennis win. Isidro Herrera has been eliminated. Now both Cody Henderson and Ryan Windsor are still playing in this event, so we don't yet know if they'll have a chance to fight Trey Birchfield for that win. So this may come down to the last game of this entire tournament, Jeff.
Three straight here for both players here on this round. Again, 5-0 Birchfield. You see him on the right. Yeah, you can tell he's kind of grimacing a little bit sometimes when he releases that bag. Double four bagger. And, you know, going back to what you were talking about, Trey, you know, I would think that the inconsistency of the pain makes it worse.
Oh, yes,
you know,
it
like,
is.
Like if it was something that was constantly, you know,
constantly hurting
or something.
But then you just
you don't know when it's going to happen. That,
right.
I think that
if
makes
all
it worse.
Of a sudden, if it, you know, we made a joke with him that, you know, there's one ACL pro that actually plays with a, you know, those little reachers that you have, like, yeah. the claw that you can grab, yeah. you know, grab things if someone's high on a shelf. One of our pros actually has bad back pain and can't bend over. So he literally has a grabber that he brings to every the whole thing. I was joking with Trey Birchfield before this tournament started. I said, you're going to use one of those grabbers just so you don't have to bend over every single time. I was mostly kidding, but at the same time, it's like anything you can do to limit any type of motion, I mean, it – you just want to limit those sudden pains that cause right. you to jerk one way or the other.
The Jordan board, give it two.
A couple of points here for Jordan Power on the four bagger. So 5-2. There's Trey Birchfield again, just 17 years old and the number two player in the world. So the number one player in the world is what, 63?
Right. Damon Dennis, yes. Yeah. He's, I believe, 60 years old, yes.
Sorry, Damon, if I'm a little over. I tell you what, he looks and acts a lot younger, I can tell you that. But yeah, so roughly 60 years old. The number two player in the world, 17.
Get over.
Yeah, I didn't like that one. Misses a little low and right.
Doesn't, yeah, because Jordan Power just bullies it out of the way.
Chance for at least two more here, and he'll tack on two more, so make it a one-point match. 5-4, so Jordan getting right back in this one quickly. Jordan has quickly become accustomed to playing under the lights here on TV. I remember talking to him earlier this season, even though he was really trying to put it out of his mind and say he was just going to strip everything down and get back to the basics, you could still tell he was a little nervous. First time on national TV earlier this season at the shootout in Erie. But he's gotten used to it.
Yeah, he has. He's got plenty of experience now.
Yep.
And it's after the experience after multiple times of playing. And now he's got a win, which means he's got even more confidence. I expect this to be an airmail.
Just missed it. A little bit too strong off the backside.
Right,
he's the type of guy that when he feels that momentum, he's going to shoot everything. He's going to play hyper-aggressive. Trey Birchfield tries a little bit of a cut there. It was almost like a combination cut-flop. He's trying to get it just to kind of hop in that left side and sneak in, but he's going to just steal a single point.
So Jordan catches a little bit of a break there and make it a two-point match now, 6-4. Trey Birchfield from Carrollton, Ohio. Just wrapped up his senior year in high school. Jordan a chance here for the tie, and he hits it, slides it right in.
So just a reminder on format, all of these four brackets are double elimination brackets. So Trey Birchfield is undefeated on the day. He came out of what we call the winner's bracket. Jordan Power already suffered a loss. He's coming out of the elimination bracket. So what that means is, in order to get to the singles playoff, Trey Birchfield just has to win this game, right? Just win the game. Jordan Power has to win two games in a row. So if this game ends and Jordan Power wins, we will, you know, go back 0-0, start it over, and run it back for a winner-take-all game two. Trey Birchfield, he wins game one or game two, he advances to the pro singles playoff for the second straight year.
No, get away.
Looking for the wash, and it just falls in. So yeah. Double four bagger will keep it tied at six.
Jordan Power-esque right there.
Yeah.
He thought Trey Birchfield bagger. Thought he missed it.
Boy, two great young players.
We do have a chance to see two of the four players that we saw in last year's pro singles playoff here at the World Championships. Adam Hister also making that singles playoff. Adam Hister actually defeated Trey and eliminated Trey Birchfield in that singles playoff. And then Hister came up short to Jamie Graham in the finals to win that 2020 World Championship.
Off the back of the board, Birchfield was trying to go for another double four bagger, but instead spins it off. And Jordan Power now has taken the lead, 9-6.
Jordan Power. It's amazing to see his rise, right? Especially if he can beat Trey Birchfield right here on the biggest stage of his career.
Absolutely.
To see him do nothing the first half of the season, and all of a sudden in Las Vegas to make a broadcast for the first time in doubles alongside Chad Webb. They make it to a bracket final, and that was just, you know, the biggest thing ever, the biggest upset. And then they come up short there, but then they continue to fight through, and then they make a broadcast again in Erie, and they beat Jimmy and Greg. Jimmy McGuffin and Greg Geary on that five-point round to end it when they were down by four, and it was this big ascension. But then they get to the finals, and they come up short, and they get beat pretty bad by Steven Bernaset and Tom Gustafson. And then all of a sudden, a couple weeks later, he's in Atlanta, and now he's in doubles, and he's right there again in the finals. Can't get there. And then in Memphis, he gets all the way finals and finally gets it done with Dave Sutton on the double side. And then all of a sudden, he's able to take that momentum, flip it over onto the single side, and ride through one of his best runs, or the best run in his career, to get where he is now on the single side. It's really, really inspirational.
And again, he's only been playing for 2.5 years. Birchfield again trying to go for the air mail, see if he could collect all three. But instead, it bounces off the back. Oh, Jordan helps him out and puts two in for Trey.
Yeah, and you know, I know some people at home are going to be like, why? Oh, no, what do you do? It's actually not a bad situation, because if Jordan Power had chosen to lay up on that front of the board there and just said, I'm good, Trey Birchfield could have thrown an airmail, which I know you're saying it's an airmail, still low percentage, but he's had two airmail opportunities on that round. If you're going to tell me Trey Birchfield's going to miss two airmails at this situation,
right,
I'm probably not going to say not probably. So going hard with that push, essentially seeing if you can get them all to guarantee three, I still think was the right call.
Ooh, and now that one a little short and to the right. And Birchfield goes to the right, helps him out a little bit. And it's going to stay 9-6, so Jordan Power is still on top. Trey comes from family, really, of cornhole. His dad and his grandpa taught him how to play when he was just a kid. He won his first tournament when he was 13 years old. And Trey, I think the one that he won, I think Virginia, is it called the Dale Shobes? Is that what it's called? The one in West Virginia? fairly significant win, though, at 13 years old. That one's in.
13 years old. Yeah, he's been playing for so long, it's like you can't even – Trey Birchfield is actually like a veteran.
It feels like it, doesn't it?
Which is the weirdest thing to think about at this point, being 18 years old.
About 7.5 hours from home down here in Rock Hill, South Carolina. That's a great look inside the facility. If you didn't know any better, you'd think that this place was built for cornhole.
It really
is. It's perfect.
You know, 100,000 square feet of basketball arena space up top on the main floor where all the preliminary qualifying play is going on. 128 sets of boards set up for the over 1,200 players that are here this weekend.
Just short.
And then down on this arena floor, we have, you know, behind us, there's a good shot of the main court, but behind this, you got four rotating feature streaming courts going on. And then you got this main stage. I mean, it's just, it's absolutely built for cornhole.
The new headquarters of the ACL down here in Rock Hill now. Oh, again, a little bit to the right. Jordan takes advantage of it.
Right now, Jordan Power just feels locked in.
He'll get at least two, and he does. Now 13-6. And again, worth noting what Trey was just talking about, that Jordan has to win twice to move on. So he's got to win this one just to force an all or nothing.
See if Trey steps out here to get a better angle. He goes up. No, he's going to go through it all. Okay. It works. Oh, and maybe that's why he did it. He wanted Jordan Power to go after the pile. And now how aggressive Jordan Power here?
Steps out to his left a little bit. Hits one, but the other one slides away.
Believe I'm saying this, but this feels like a must-have, and he did have it. It's weird to think about Trey Birchfield in a situation where he had to have a bag.
This was 6-4, Birchfield at one point.
13-8. Gets around there, but that bag's as good as in. Again. Perchfield has not been bad this game at all. Ooh, that was hyper aggressive.
Yes.
Talk about confidence. That was a 1,000,000% confidence right there. Oh my word.
And it is a 10-2 run right now for Jordan Power. Again, it was 6-4 Birchfield. Trey is the number two player in the world. Off to the right.
Wow.
Okay. he is. I mean, he's just oozing confidence right now. He's like, it's okay. That's all right. And now Birchfield to the right. Power just pushes right through it. See if Birchfield with the airmail almost able to drag it in. That's as good as down, right?
Yeah, that's as good as in.
And there it goes. Four baggers, so a couple of points here for Birchfield.
Birchfield hanging around in this game.
14-10. Again, first one to 21 or over. If Trey wins it, he advances. And Jordan's week comes to an end here on the single side. In case you're just tuning in, Jordan Power, to start the broadcast, eliminated Greg Geary. He missed only six bags the entire match. He hit 66 out of 72. Hit 30 straight at one point, and 50 of his last 52. A four bagger here.
He's doing, he's relentless right now.
16 to
10. Yeah, Trey Birchfield in this game is throwing a 10.42 points per round average and losing. Jordan Power at 10.74 points per round and 58% four baggers. Here comes an airmail, promise.
A little too short. Flies off the back.
What
and
time?
Power pushes right through it.
Now this has got to be in.
And it
y'all
is. Boy, Trey, we talk about this all the time. It's one thing to make the board messy and to throw a block. It's another thing then to be able to score off it, and that's exactly what Power did. Threw the block and then pushed it right in.
Watch this. Watch this shot by Jordan Power again to push it all. That's a pretty shallow block. Requires pinpoint precision in order to do that.
You know, we talk a lot about board conditions and bags and sticky side and slick side. It seems, Trey, like the boards right now are just perfect. I mean,
yeah.
It seems like the players are just kind of doing whatever they want right now.
And that will do it for game one. We're going to a winner-take-all game two.
So Jordan Power now has won two straight to stay alive.
Sudden death game right here.
Everything's going in. He can't even spin the bag right. He's just trying to spin it to see who goes first, and it still goes in the hole. must be nice.
These bags are live.
And here we go right away. Winner take all right here.
I will say that Cody Henderson was just eliminated from the tournament. So
number three goes down.
So Trey Birchfield has a real legitimate opportunity here.
God damn it.
Trey. That's going to be 2 points for Trey Birchfield early.
Trey buries the airmail for the four bagger. As you said, plus two here in the first round.
Wow. Did you hear that?
No, what do you think?
That boy said that was live.
Trey Birchfield did not realize those bags were live.
When he threw that airmail.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. Must be nice to be number two in the world.
Yeah, must be nice to just score 2 points when you didn't even know the game had started yet.
Yeah, you could hear the announcement. Of course, he's wearing the earbuds, but you heard the announcement.
Right.
Stacy Moore, the commissioner, is right behind us. He said these bags are live. But with earbuds in, obviously, couldn't hear it. And Power easily slides it in.
Close to the crowd. I love this.
Gets a couple of points back, and Jordan loving the crowd. We all are. Again, these are the bracket finals here in our live coverage here at the 2021 ACL World Championships. Four brackets, each of them started with 64 players. And we're down to the bracket finals on each of the four. What a week. And of course, about 1,200 players, all different levels. A lot on the line this week, not only for the World Championships, but Trey, you also have people here just trying to get to what basically, in a sense, what is their tour card, right?
Yeah, trying to become ACL pros, especially on Sunday. On Sunday, we will have the ACL Pro Qualifier, 512 players from across the country competing for 34 spots in the ACL Pro Division next season. Talk about pressure.
Absolutely.
There will be in that qualifier, based on the format, you'll like this, Jeff, 16 games once we get down to the end of it. There'll be 16 games where if you win, you're an ACL pro. If you lose, you're not.
Got to wait till next year. Wow. That's tough.
Talk about pressure.
Yeah. There's just so many players, though. That's the way you got to do it, right? Have to win. I mean, really, you know, to get your tour card in golf is a lot of pressure. Really no difference. You got to win.
Oh, my word, Trey Birchfield. How did he find a way in right there?
Yeah, how did that bag, how did Power's bag not drop?
5-2.
Trey, three there, make it 5-2.
Now, the thing is, Ryan Windsor is also still in this tournament, who is obviously the number four player, so he can still catch Trey Birchfield as well. But if Jordan, the happiest man in the building, if Jordan Power wins and Kyle Malone ends up beating Ryan Windsor right now, is going to be Damon Dennis. He's going to kind of back his way into that number one overall ranking, which would be the 2021 Man of the Year. That is an award. Man of the Year, Woman of the Year, and Team of the Year are all three awards that are awarded to the best, highest-ranked players or teams at the end of the point season, which includes the World Championships.
Meanwhile, Birchfield, another four-bagger. A couple of more points. Now 7-2. An opportunity now for Power. Misses to the right.
Jordan Power trying to tell himself to stop missing, considering he's missed about three bags in the past four games.
I don't know if he can grab that or not. Can't do it. Slides past it.
And
that'll be a washer in this round. So still a five-point lead now for Trey Birchfield. And Birchfield, a couple of wins here in 2021, singles champion at the Las Vegas National. That huge win over Damon Dennis. Second place at the Wichita National. The win over Steven Bernicet.
You know what's hard, Jeff, is beating Trey Birchfield. You know what's really hard?
Beating him twice. I knew exactly where you're going with that, and I agree.
I love Jordan Power's airmails because they are not, like, super high. I mean, they are lasers.
Hits right. Another one.
You get the boom on the fist pump.
Stays 7-2. I thought he might try to do a hard push and see if he could maybe collect that bag that was in front of the hole. I know it was kind of near Trey's bag, but. Early opportunity here for Jordan maybe to get 2 points back. Not sure Trey's going to be able to grab that one.
Ooh,
now a chance
now
maybe at four.
Yeah, this could be a real big round here for Jordan Power in for four to make it 7-6.
You are right about the four spot, whoever said it.
It is a four spot for Jordan Power, and just like that, a one-point match. 7-6.
You ain't afraid to talk to the crowd.
Love that. It is so much fun in this sport to be able to hear the players. You know, one of my favorites was when we were in Atlanta a few weeks ago and Ryan Smith was mic'd up and you could actually hear him talking strategy to himself
right. The
whole time. Remember?
Yes, absolutely.
There were even times where, you know, let's say he didn't have a good round. He's like, it's okay. I'll give up two. I'll get him next time. I mean, you can literally hear himself
right. Pumping
himself up. It's great. It's good stuff.
Oh.
Yeah, he didn't like it. And now Birchfield is in. So was a 1 point match, and now Trey's going to get a couple more back to make it 9-6.
Right, yeah, I mean, Trey Birchfield, he's robotic. I mean, they call him the robot for a reason. Now, this doesn't mean he's not feeling it. I think the good news is that I haven't seen any wincing or anything like that. I've been trying to pay attention to how he reacts after certain shots, and I'm not seeing anything that is alarming as far as pain goes. That now, again, he could be just very good at masking that. I expect an airmail here.
Goes over the top of it.
See if Power can push it.
Gets one out of the two, so the strategy works for Trey Birchfield.
11-6.
And now 11-6. Right here, Trey, look at him right there. That's the only time I was going to say that I noticed it.
Right.
When he goes to pick up his bag, he's just not getting that full knee bend. I think that's where it's probably pinching him a little bit.
Now, on that last round, you know, Birchfield had the option to block behind and force an airmail by Power. But I think there's two reasons he didn't do that. One, you don't want to go for a double block, miss to the left, then create a bump or make an easy push for your opponent. But two, I think more importantly, I think he recognizes you can't let Jordan Power hit big shots. He's such a momentum guy.
Yes.
He reminds me a lot of like someone like an Eric Anderson, where it's you let him start hitting big shots and rolls, or even an Eric Davis, really. And now Eric Davis is definitely not as vocal as Jordan Power, but more of what I'm getting at is the big shots propel guys like that. He's not a bag for bag. He's not going to gain a lot of momentum from throwing 30 bags, you know, slide, slide, slide. But if you let him hit the airmails, you let him hit the big shots, he just seems to get even more fired up and more fired up.
No, I totally agree. He is a momentum player without a doubt.
You're pointing in the crowd to somebody. Who'd you pick out of there?
You know who I just saw, who I haven't seen in a long time?
Who?
Austin Slowbaum.
Yeah, Austin Slowbaum.
Oh, what a shot by Trey Birchfield.
A drag by Birchfield is just going to be two, could have been four.
Another four-bagger.
You hear it on the intercom. Here's this replay again. Going for the drag, super aggressive. He doesn't care. He wants it. I was going to say, Austin Slowbaum, through open standings, has qualified to be an ACL pro next season.
So. Love that. He is a fun player to watch. Really burst on the scene. Well, in my time anyway, 2019 going right into 20, Myrtle Beach at the college championships.
Ooh, and now will Birchfield, what does he do immediately? Does he immediately go up? No, he's going to roll. Interesting. Now this is a lot to push, but Power's got the power.
It's still stuck there on that backside, and now a double clutch here by Birchfield.
All right. Trey's going to take one of his two timeouts. You get two timeouts in singles play. So he's going to take one of them here. He just wanted a brief glance. Now, again, I'm not sure what you want. You could go push. You could go cut. To go from here kind of across the board that way. You could go airmail. Or you could, okay. That's not a terrible shot because Jordan Power wants so bad to throw this airmail. He's just worried if I throw the airmail and drag this, it's not worth anything.
Goes for it and hits the backside, but it won't fall.
I mean, he's right. It needed to be a backside airmail.
Yeah.
So he hit where he wanted to. He just got too much of the lip. So, I mean, he can't be that upset. I know he's bummed it didn't go, but at the same time, you'd rather be deep and hit that lip exactly like he did than be a little bit short, knock in Trey Birchfield's bag, and then you trampoline off the back.
Boy, literally, you could see on that replay, it was a great shot. He literally just went an inch too deep. Well, this is a big point in this match right here, obviously. 13-6. And Jordan obviously doesn't want to let Trey get any further away. And again, this is do or die right now. Power has won two straight here to stay alive. Again, the number one player in the world has been eliminated. And number three has gone down already here just in the bracket finals.
Number two and number four still remain. Kyle Malone and Ryan Windsor are going head-to-head right now. It's 7-7 in that game.
Well, that last shot by Power was so good. Set himself up for both of his bags to drop.
Ooh, will Trey Birchfield go with a drag here? He is.
Oh, my gosh. And this one ever so gently, but he does bring in Trey's bag. What a round.
It just feels like Trey Birchfield right now is saying with this shot selection, you are not getting first bag back, Jordan. I'm not going to give it to you. It almost feels like what I'm seeing is Trey is saying, I feel like Jordan is such a momentum player, I can't even let him have that opportunity. And so he's being extra risky in order to make Jordan Power chase him. And it feels like he feels it so much more of an advantage.
But I would also, just to add to that, Trey, say that Birchfield's airmail right now is so locked in. I mean, he's also proving he's not afraid of it.
Right.
Goes four straight up the middle, and Jordan with the miss. So Birchfield chipping away now, makes it 15-6.
Trey Birchfield now six points away.
Believe in yourself. Dig deep.
Here, Jordan Power talking to himself, saying he's got to dig deep here as Birchfield hits the first one. We've talked about these situations before. It just puts so much pressure on you when you know you have to hit every bag, and that's what Jordan's looking at right now. I mean, Trey is just absolutely locked in.
It feels like the two roles have reversed in the first and the second game. Jordan Power, Trey Birchfield was finding ways to manufacture a point here and there, but it almost felt like Jordan Power had complete control over that first game. The second game has a complete opposite feel. Feels like Jordan Power's been able to manufacture some points at times, but Trey Birchfield has felt completely in control of this game, and now that's kind of the first blemish we've seen in a while.
Yeah, first one in what, probably about four rounds.
Jordan Power has to take advantage here.
Well, and this is exactly what we were just talking about, Trey. I mean, it's like a basketball game. I mean, you just can't give any momentum up to Jordan Power, and that's exactly what he's done as Power gets the four-bagger and 4 points.
Jordan, a four-bagger and 4 points.
That's a huge 4 points.
And there's that momentum switch you were talking about, Trey. I mean, you're exactly right. He gets it back, and, boy, he and Uncle Mo can go a long way.
I'll give you one guess what comes here.
Yep. Oh,
wow.
Goes in behind it. I thought he was going to airmail too. Again, just shows you that change in the momentum. Oh, he's got to go for it here, right?
Oh, absolutely. No doubt.
I'm actually surprised there was any hesitation. Whoa. Blocks in behind. Was he worried that Power would maybe
I think he just wanted to maintain this control, forcing Power to no, Power's not going to lay up. Now he can hit a drag for 3 points, though. Maybe that's what he was trying to do, was that just outmaneuver Power in this round.
On the way, and does drag it in. Huge shot for Trey Birchfield. Wow.
Well, I tip my hat to Trey Birchfield. Made us look foolish right there. Did that to absolute perfection. Hits the drag. Makes Jordan Power think about an airmail. Has to throw it deep to avoid Birchfield's bags. And then Birchfield nails the airmail drag.
And again, back to the airmail that he is just being able to throw at will right now.
He's relentless.
Yeah. So hard to do, even at this level.
And now he's 3 points away. Oh, and will he go airmail here?
Hits
it, and now this one bag's got to be in.
And it is, Trey.
Woo!
Jordan Power giving it to you, Trey Ryder.
Yeah, he knew it. He knew it was coming. He knew it was coming.
I hear you, Trey Ryder.
He's been in this situation before.
Birchfield still with the honors. 18-10.
Oh, now he wants to sit here. He wants to be in front of the hole. Don't take them all. You see how it just trickled in. He just threw it an inch too hard.
Right.
But that's fine. I mean, obviously, Jeff, in the hole is okay. I'm just saying, in that particular situation, the reason he wanted to leave it a little bit short, it just made the shot, the follow-up shot by Jordan Power, that much more difficult to deal with. That's the reason he thought about changing that strategy.
Well, is it safe to say this has been a workmanlike effort for Birchfield?
Absolutely.
He's just been chipping away. Remember, this game was actually tied at 6 at one point. And now 18-10 Birchfield. I mean, just doing it a couple points here and there.
Oh, and now a four-bagger will win it by Trey Birchfield. Will he go for an airmail drag to win this event and go to a pro singles playoff? He chooses to.
Oh, decision time here for Jordan, Trey.
actually,
he's trying to do the math here.
There's no, I was going to say, there's no decision to make
just
here.
Just don't throw it, right?
You hold that bag, you walk to the other end, and you pick up those bags, and you concede 2 points.
So 20 to 10.
That is a huge break for Jordan Power.
Yeah, it only took him just a second to realize it. He's like, nah.
Not a chance in the world, he says, I'm throwing that bag.
Just try and survive for another round here. Birchfield pinches it in.
It is pinched. So now, how aggressive is Power going to be? Oh, and well, actually, this bag looks like it's falling, so Power may not be completely out of it yet. It moves there. Now Power has to go in without that Birchfield bag.
And he does. Just sneaks it in to stay alive.
That's a wash.
This is a great shot here. Has to hit the left side. Cannot bring in that lucky bag surefire by Birchfield. You see, oh, beautiful.
So much pressure on every bag right now for Jordan Power. Every bag has got to go in.
Oh, and now Power can go in for a couple.
No.
And it goes off the back, and that's going to be the point that Trey Birchfield needs. So number two survives.
Unbelievable. Almost feels, it just hurts to have it end like that, Jeff. You almost wanted a big airmail or something to end it, but Jordan Power, what a performance. He gave Trey Birchfield, the robot, the number two player in the world, everything he could handle. But Birchfield off to a singles playoff for the second straight year.
Back-to-back wins for Jordan Power, but in the end, number two, Trey Birchfield, survives and advances here in Rock Hill. Well, a developing situation here in Rock Hill as the next matchup was due to be Adam Hissner against Mike Harvey. And as the matches go, again, we go from 64 in each bracket all the way down to the bracket finals. Players are on a clock in between matches, and right now Mike Harvey is dangerously close from being disqualified.
Yeah, he's about to get forfeited.
60 seconds.
So that clock down to 60 seconds. I'm sure people are trying to text and call his phone. Mike Harvey just having a sensational year here in 2021, has really burst on the scene, and we were really looking forward to seeing this matchup against Adam Hissner, who obviously is just one of the favorites and one of just the blue bloods of this sport. So this was going to be a great matchup, and Mike Harvey is dangerously close from being DQ'd here in the bracket finals of the World Championships.
Talk about, wow. Talk about the worst situation.
Here he comes.
He became about 15 seconds away.
20 seconds.
You get one down.
Yeah, that was close. And again, you will not meet a nicer guy in this sport. Mike Harvey, just a terrific guy out of Chesapeake, Virginia. Again, he's had just an amazing year, just has not been able to get that big signature win yet, but has lost right there in the finals and semifinals so many times this year. We'll talk more about that as we go along. They're trying to get his mic on him right now, but there is Adam Hissner. So Adam gets a few extra practice rounds, and Adam, of course, has been having a terrific year as well. Adam Hissner out of New Philadelphia, Ohio. So while we wait to get Mike Harvey mic'd up, here's a look at the upcoming schedule here at the ACL 2021 World Championships here in Rock Hill, South Carolina. The ACL Celebrity Throwdown on ESPN2 tomorrow night. Join us at 9 Eastern. Trey and I will have the call on that one. And then back to the World Championships of Pro Singles. The semifinals of the championship on Saturday at 1 Eastern on ESPN, and then back to ESPN2 on Sunday for the Pro Doubles semifinals. And World Championship again here in Rock Hill, South Carolina. Beautiful facility just south of Uptown Charlotte. There's Mike Harvey on the left, all mic'd up and ready to go. He'll get one practice round, and away we go.
Losers bracket A. And
Mike Harvey going with the red all slides. Adam Hissner going with his signature yellow local bag Outlaws.
And the honors for Adam Hissner. First one is in. Hissner again having a really good year, consistently top 25 player in the world. And lost in a doubles final in a pro shootout in Asheville earlier. Lost in a doubles final again in the national in Las Vegas. I mean, it was just right there. And then broke through winning men's singles in the sixth pro shootout in Memphis. So again, another guy who's just been right there all year, but Hissner able to get that big win in Memphis.
Going to be 2-0 here again. So this is a another loser's bracket final or elimination bracket final. So the loser of this game will be eliminated. They finish. The winner will go on to the bracket final to play Duncan Clemmer, who is undefeated. And in that game, similar to what we had between Jordan Power and Trey Birchfield, the winner of this game will have to beat Duncan Clemmer twice.
So do or die here first, right?
Absolutely. And Hissner going to go for a hard push to only push his bag. And now will we see a Harvey airmail that he became so notorious for, both in Asheville and at the final chase? No, he chooses to block behind. Now what will Hissner do? Hissner might try a little bit of a roll or a wheel. Nope, he's just going to lay. He's just going to lay behind, say, Mike, I'm going to let you do what you think you can do. He may be able to drag this bag, but right now Hissner's plus +3. If he's off the board, Hissner will get 3. In the hole will be a wash. If he can drag it, Harvey will get 2.
Going way up top, and he is able to hit the pile and just push one of his bags in.
Yeah, that's not bad. He was going for a short airmail for that drag. Left it a little too short, but the good news is he's able to knock his in and stay on top of that pile. So that'll work for what he was trying to accomplish.
Again, just hammered it down on the pile and pushes one of his own bags in. So 2-0 Adam Hissner here early on.
Adam Hisner always plays well at these World Championships. Has two second place finishes, has a fifth place finish, and a 13th place finish. So, I mean, he is notorious for delivering at this stage.
Off the back there, give Adam three.
Make too it strong five. Off the back to make it 5-0.
Yeah.
Hisner.
So it was a wash down.
Now Mike Harvey, very emotional player. So much fun to watch. Again, he's out of Chesapeake, Virginia. There he is on the left, always has a smile on his face. He's been playing cornhole for about 7 years. See, left-handed. He's got a cut shot. Can actually curve the bag both ways. I think that's probably one of his strongest strategies. Slowing things down a little bit. Spins that one in.
And now Harvey, will he go try to get around? Yeah, I was going to say, I'm surprised he's not stepping out. He can't. His bags can kind of morph around. Oh, but he threw it a little too hard. Going to give up another point to Hisner.
Oh, and that one hurts again. He can, with that left hand of his, he can cut it both ways. Like you said, Trey, he's just trying to just cut around it and sneak it in on the back door.
Yeah, trying to just morph and melt around that. Those all slides and the game changer bags are so well known for just being, I love that term. I forget who taught me, but melt. It feels like the bag melts into the hole, melts around bags.
6-0, Hisner. There's a good look at the bags there for Mike Harvey, former teacher and high school basketball coach. Was actually a great high school basketball player. Team captain his senior year.
Oh, that's a perfect bag, because what it did was, this bag is better than being in, because it essentially grabbed onto this bag. And now, if this one goes, this one will go as well.
There was that melting action you talked about. Oh, big shot for Hisner.
That was beautifully set up. He set up the third bag so that it would grab it, and then the fourth bag to take it all.
And Hisner is going to get more points as, again, Harvey too strong off the back of the board.
Oh, man.
9-0 Adam Hisner.
He's wearing that smile, but a frustrated smile.
All business right now for Adam Hisner.
And that is a block. That is as good as it gets. It's a flat block right in the center, and it causes a kick from Harvey. Now he'll look to replace. He's a little bit right, probably out of play. Now, here's the benefit. You already saw the benefits of throwing a bag like an all slide that'll melt into the hole. Here's the downside. It's hard to grab. Because it melts around bags, it's not very grabbable. Whereas Hisner, it's hard to get around bags because his bags are so bulky. But the positive is that he grabs very easily. Okay.
Went for the airmail.
He did go for the airmail for the drag. He just missed the airmail. But now Harvey has to go and just limit it to two.
Good. Pretty.
And he does.
There's a pro and a con to every type of bag that you throw. Adam Hisner is throwing a thicker, stickier bag. It is used for pushing. It is used for collecting and grabbing and blocking and all of those different things. Mike Harvey, he just wants every bag to go in the hole. And so whether it's an airmail or a slide, a get around, whatever, he's using it to get around bag like that. That is exactly why he's choosing that set of bags. But Adam is choosing his set of bags because he wants that local bag outlaw to sit right there. He doesn't want it to move. Just shows the contrasting styles. Watch this cut. See, it went, that took a beeline that way. Mm-hmm. Okay, instead of going straight up the board, that one went hard at an angle. Now, the problem is he landed here when he wanted to land here
right. And
kind of cut that way.
Oh, nice bag by Mike Harvey.
Now, watch, you got to hit this point, that V right there. And he didn't. He hit that side, got deflected, and now, again, the melt bags. He wants the all cornhole, all slides, because he wants to hit this bag, use it as a bumper, and just kind of melt in that left side.
Easy, baby.
Easy. And it does, Trey, exactly what you just said. Just oozed its way in, and Mike Harvey is going to get on the board now.
That's as good as it gets. That's exactly what he wanted.
Make it 11-4. Yes, sir. That's a great description, like you're talking about, Trey, just kind of melting into the hole.
There's that cut. And that bag is probably as good as in. The question becomes on this bag. I think it will go because this is such a good block here, and it will probably grab that all slide. But the problem, okay, now Hissner, hard as he can this way. Doesn't matter what happens. Yeah, he's like, it doesn't matter because this bag's essentially out of play. It's not very grabbable. If this was a Hissner bag, if this was yellow and Hissner was in Harvey's position, he could step out and grab this bag. But that red bag is not very apt to be grabbed or collected.
And now Hissner with a chance to get them all right back here. Looking for a four bagger. And oh, man, he was looking for an and one shot, being aggressive, trying to knock Mike Harvey's off the backside and put his in the hole.
You're exactly correct. He wanted an and one and almost got it. Watch this. That bag moves, and it just doesn't fall. Came as close as you can get.
Oh, he wanted it bad. Makes it 13-4. One of the great shots in the sport. You don't see it very often. Well, he knew it, though. As soon as he saw it, he knew it.
And now Harvey can get around this pretty easy. I shouldn't say easy. It's a semi-difficult shot to do, but he's shown he can do it many times. The question for me is, can Hissner find a way to get these bags?
First things first, can he cut it right to left like he's talked about being able to do? He likes it.
Hissner wants to hit that corner.
Oh, just missed it.
And now, again, this is perfect for Harvey. Hit the right side. You can go in without Hissner's.
Oh, wow, look at that. Takes one of Hissner's, but still drops in two. And a good round for Mike Harvey.
Make it 13-8.
From 13-0 to 13-8.
Good shot again here. And he just morphs in there.
What a comeback here for Mike Harvey. Again, the winner of this one moves on.
Stop. There we are.
On the loser side, your week is down on the single side.
Hissner thought he missed that bag, but it did cut enough. Catch the back side of the hole.
So we saw Harvey have to work his bags right to left in the last round, this time having to go left to right a little bit.
Okay, best shot is in between these bags, not in the hole. He wanted to do that, but he kicked too far right. He wanted to be right here because it would have made a very difficult life for Harvey.
Yeah. Harvey just right down the middle. This one for a wash, and it flops over the hole. So the comeback continues now for Mike Harvey.
I know you missed that.
I deserve that. I missed that.
You playing, boy. You got me locked in.
From 13-0 to 13-10.
And I wonder, based on that little exchange that I just heard, I wonder if that and one attempt by Adam Hissner fired up Mike Harvey in a way. Oh, that didn't help. You didn't want that because now you have a lane for a hard push. Oh, well, Hissner didn't hit it. So, I mean, you are off the hook. That's the good news for Harvey.
So again,
normally,
Harvey,
I'd say, you know, being in front is okay, but when you set lanes for your opponent, that's when you kind of get in trouble.
Missed it to the right. Hissner misses.
It's a good round for Harvey to score because he's got a pretty clean lane. Hissner's lane is a lot skinnier.
Yeah, picks up one there, so he's showing six.
Good
and
shot.
Hissner
like that.
Hits that one in, so that limits it to what, just 1 point for Harvey, but still. Pretty. The comeback, again, still continues here for Harvey, 11 straight. Boy, Adam was so locked in early, and Harvey just couldn't quite find the momentum. But wow, this one has totally flipped on its head. Hissner kind of stepping out a little bit. See if he can get some momentum back here in this round.
That bag is a little bit short left.
Damn.
And again, Harvey set up to tie up this game.
Yep. Oh, it's gone, baby.
Off the back. He was right. So Harvey gives it right back. Bag is in.
Thank you.
And Hester shot. Able to get some more points
Sid
now.
Mike.
So that snaps the 11-0 run by Harvey.
now it's going to be very interesting. I would anticipate a block right in front of the hole here. Okay, and he chooses to make Harvey chase him. Now, Harvey's definitely not going to put up a block. I promise you that. But I just anticipated Hisner trying to get in the front and get in front here.
You know, yeah. I guess, Trey, I mean, do you ever feel like you're just the better player?
Oh, come on.
And you just want to go back for back?
Damn.
Ooh, here's an opportunity for five here at a minimum. He's going to try to cut around. Beautiful.
What a cut shot for Hisner.
This is such a hard decision because that is such a low percentage push. He's going for it anyway.
And gets one, almost the other, as it just hangs on the lip. It's not going. Unless they want to do a sweep underneath. I don't think it's stuck
in
anything.
No. And we had the court official, Josh Keck, right next to it looking at it. And that's going to be a five-point round, though. I cannot believe that bag held up.
19 to 11. It was 13 to nothing, Hisner. Then 13 to 11. And just like that, a 6-0 run by Hisner.
This is the block I expected to see. Harvey can still get around this. I don't. He might step out. Okay, there it is. I was going to say, might step out a little. Don't need much. Perfect. Maybe not perfect, but it's pretty darn good.
Adam just pushes right through it.
Oh.
Doesn't
dang.
Like it again off the
in
back
for the
of the
win.
Board. And now here's this
that.
One is over.
Adam Hisner will advance to this bracket final here in bracket A to take on Duncan Flemmer for a chance to get to his second straight pro singles playoff here at the World Championships.
Adam Hisner.
I got double dip now.
Let's out a huge boom. What a sigh of relief after an 11-0 run by Mike Harvey. Adam Hisner puts it away and moves on.
The most versatile outdoor cooking machine ever. Savory wood-fired flavor. Experience Pit Boss. Hurry, get the best deals now at pitboss-grills.com.
AllCornhole.com has the largest online selection of cornhole bags for players of all levels. Through years of research and development, AllCornhole.com has the perfect bags for even pro-level players. With over four unique series to choose from, including Game Changers, All Slides, Slide Rights, and Steadies, you'll be sure to find the right bags to dominate the competition. Whether you're looking for bags for family gatherings, competitive league night, or the pro circuit, go to AllCornhole.com to get the perfect boards and bags for you.
It's gonna smell like grilling out there, America. Hamburgers and hot dogs, mostly. At Johnsonville, that breaks our hearts. Because our family-owned company has been making sausage in Johnsonville, Wisconsin, since 1945. How can hamburgers and hot dogs be our national tradition when you can't even spell sausage without USA? So exercise your right to mix it up, grillers, and throw on some Johnsonville sausage, because freedom is delicious.
My name is James Baldwin.
Samantha Finley.
My name is Cody Henderson, and I'm an ACL pro.
On the way. What a shot
That's as good as it gets.
The American Cornhole League.
Anyone can play.
Anyone can win.
From the time he was five, Ryan Newman believed two things. He could drive and he could win. Driver of the Year, Daytona, Brickyard. But my man still hasn't won the cup. That's okay, because he still believes he will. Guaranteed Rate believes in your dreams. That's why we treat everyone like we treat our own family and work extra hard to get you the lowest low rate possible. Because if you believe, you will.
They say there's no such thing as a free lunch, but there is at DraftKings. You can compete for thousands in prizes in our free-to-play pools without spending a dime. Put your knowledge to the test by answering questions about specific games or events. The more you pick right, the better your shot to win and chow down on a cash casserole. Casserole. Download the DraftKings app now. Enter with the promo code, play free for thousands, and make it rain.
Back inside the Rock Hill Sports and Event Center here in Rock Hill, South Carolina. Great to see the fans here in the Palmetto State here this week. A lot of pros and some fans in the house here in Rock Hill. So, again, this week has started with four brackets of 64 players each. So 256 total players. Trey, we are down to our final eight. Looking for our final four, really down to our final seven because Trey Birchfield's already advanced.
Yeah, this is going to be an interesting finale here. And I can't wait to see how this works out.
So Duncan Klemmer on the broadcast court here against Adam Hissner. And, boy, it sounds like Duncan Klemmer, Trey, has had a day.
All right. These next bags will be live.
All right. Good luck, buddy.
All right. These bags are live.
Hissner there on the left. Duncan Klemmer, welcome to the stage. There in the red pants on the right.
First bag by Duncan Klemmer. And it's a little bit off to the right. Anytime I get a player in their first appearance on a broadcast, I want to know how they're going to perform. Duncan Klemmer all day has been unbelievable. Unbelievable. Roll shots, airmails, bag for bag. Doesn't matter. He has been so good. The problem is he's had a large layoff, okay? He's had time to sit and think about this. It's his first broadcast. He's been sitting, well, maybe not sitting, maybe practicing, but he hasn't played a competitive game in maybe an hour and a half now because he's been waiting for this, okay? Adam Hissner, on the other hand, had just came off a win, and a pretty darn impressive win against Mike Harvey. Don't be surprised if it takes a little bit of time for Duncan Klemmer to just get into a rhythm, okay? Hissner may go out to an 8-0, 10-0 lead. But if we see the Duncan Klemmer that we saw earlier in the day, once he gets back into that rhythm, we'll see a Duncan Klemmer that can win this and get to his first ever singles playoff.
Ah.
Boy, beautiful flat bag there by Duncan Klemmer and spins it in. Double four bagger, so still a 4-0 lead here early for Adam Hissner.
Gotta put the vape away. Oh, my bad.
Well, we talked about it earlier with Jordan Power, Trey, exactly what you're talking about. That with Jordan Power this season being on national TV for the first time, but then kept, you know, working his way back to the broadcast court and then finally really took a big step and made it all the way here to the bracket finals before losing today. Really kind of got used to that big stage. And like you said, it'll be interesting to see how quickly Klemmer adjusts here. Yeah, try that flop shot, it goes over the hole.
Yeah, he's so good at those roll shots, so expect a lot of those rolls.
Back-to-back airmails for Hissner. And Klemmer with the answer. Hissner helps out Klemmer. And he ends up bouncing it off to the right.
That's a bag. Klemmer probably wants back here. But 4-1.
Honors here to Klemmer. Boy, that bag is beautiful, Trey.
It really is.
You talk about a flat bag. That thing is absolutely flat.
And the thing is, he has such good control over it. Sometimes it'll be flat, and then sometimes he'll flip it over, or not flip it over. Sometimes he'll put an angle on when he wants to roll. So he has such great control.
That is a beautiful bag. And now Clemmer with a big opportunity here up the middle and in. And Hissner's bag drops off the back.
This has got to go in just a limit to five, and that's where it'll be. Duncan Clemmer takes a lead.
From 4-0 quickly up to the first round to 6-4 Clemmer. Well, has that answered your question?
Yeah, he's ready.
Yeah,
he's ready.
Didn't take long. One round, I guess. Give up four in that first round. Well, that's what's been really fun to watch is the roll bag kind of evolve over the last year, year and a half. And I can see why Clemmer would be so good at it, because his bag is so flat, but yet when he angles his wrist ever so slightly, gets the angle on the bag, you can see how it wants to move.
Meanwhile, that push by Adam Hissner was absurd.
And
that bag was pinned underneath a roll bag attempt by Duncan Clemmer, and Hissner just flipped it over on the slick side and said, watch this. I'm going to take this with me. Here you go. Grab my hand. Here we go. We're in the hole.
It's just ripped it from out underneath Clemmer's bag.
Outrageous.
Literally just plucked it out of there. Nice shot.
There's that roll. Placed. Now another roll. This time takes it in with it.
Four bagger for Hissner. And now Clemmer with the answer. It'll stay tied at six.
That's a one.
Boy, two really good players. Wow, these guys fun to watch. You know, one of my favorite bags that Hissner throws is just that low, just line drive spinner to just push bags up. I just love that.
There's that roll. Will he do it again? Absolutely. Watch this. Again. Oh, it didn't get all the way over. That's fine. That's the good news is if you miss it short, it just sits in front like a blocker.
Well, that's why it's become such a popular shot, right, Trey?
I mean, right.
Not quite as much of a risk. Oh, that is dirty. Are you kidding me?
Finish.
And Clemmer puts them both in. What a round.
That was disgusting. Absolutely disgusting. What? I don't even know. What replay you guys giving us? Okay, we're going to do the roll first. Yeah, that is outrageous.
That was a good shot.
Oh, and then here's the push. I mean, come on. He like rolled pushed something. I don't have a word for that.
That was just dirty. Fantastic. 8-6. Clemmer with a 2-point lead. And again, Hissner just hammers in the airmail.
And will Clemmer go airmail to drag all these? Will he go push? Looks like he's going push.
And he's going to stay low and pushes all three in.
And Duncan Clemmer is making a name for himself on this stage.
After being down to 4-0, now 10-6. Look at this shot. Takes all three.
And here's the reaction. He knows what it means to be on this stage. He knows how hard it is to get here.
Little short right. See if he can try to somehow collect that as Hissner goes right in.
He left. No.
Now, will he go after
this
bag?
Come on. Get him.
Oh, they're plugged for the moment. Will it stay that way? Hissner spins it in and grabs Clemmer's bag with it. It's going to be in a wash. Whoa.
I have no idea how those bags just stayed there.
Still 10-6. Clemmer, again, having a day. Hissner's got to win twice, and right now he's down four.
Oh, opportunity.
At least two, and that's exactly what he'll get. Now 12-6, Clemmer.
I could not be more impressed with how Duncan Clemmer is handling this stage. Look, you know someone's got the talent, right, Jeff? I mean, it's one thing for someone to have the ability. It's another thing for them to be able to deliver in this arena full of people on a biggest stage of your career against a player that's coming off of a huge win, that has been here, has done that, has dominated for years. I mean, it's just,
you're right.
It's impressive.
Yeah, I mean, so many dynamics against him just stepping out of the court, right, for this first game. I think the biggest one is what you talked about, Trey. You know, when you get a player who's been playing and having success and winning, meanwhile, the other player is having to sit and wait and watch, that's a huge advantage for the player who's just been playing and winning.
Right, that's why sometimes it almost benefits you to come through the elimination bracket. In for two.
And Hissner gets a couple back here, makes it 12-8.
Now, here's the thing, right? Doesn't it feel like Duncan Clemmer's dominated this game?
Yes. 4-point game.
And it's a 4-point game. Yep. That's the only thing I'm worried about.
Well, I mean, those were basically the two big things you talked about, right, before this one started. One, how long will it take him to adjust? And then two, how does he respond when the pressure mounts?
Now, the thing is, if Hissner continues to put backs onto the right like that, the pressure completely comes off, right? Because then all you have to do, you don't have to do anything special.
Like that.
Oh, my gosh.
Off the back. Oh, big decision here for Clemmer. The crowd wants him to do it again.
Oh, you know it's coming, Jeff. This is a huge shot. This place is going to go wild if he hits it.
On the way. Love it.
Still
just misses
get
off
two.
The back. The crowd is totally into this.
Give Duncan two, make it 14-8.
This place would have exploded if he hit that shot.
Agreed. They were ready. Trying to flop it, kind of cut it in, can't do it. Oh, big push shot there for Hissner. Now Adam with the chance here to get a couple back. And he does, so 14-10. ACL ACL World Championships here in Rock Hill, South Carolina. Adam Hissner there on the left, needing to win twice. Clemmer has been sensational today.
And on the other court, Eddie Grindersleeve has eliminated Brett Guy from the tournament. So now the final bracket final that we'll deliver will be Cheyenne Renner versus Eddie Grindersleeve.
And that has been another huge storyline, is Cheyenne Renner. See if Hissner can grab it. Ooh, too hard. Missed it off the back. And now another opportunity here for Clemmer. It really kind of helps out Hissner a little bit.
Right. He's like, it doesn't matter now. I'm going to be plus three. I don't care if I take your bag in. I don't need to be greedy to try to get five. I'd love a 3 points right now. But maybe he can sneak in for five. No, he'll still take the three. Three is completely fine. Three is as good as it gets right now.
17-10. And now Clemmer getting awfully close. 4 points away. Again, Hissner has to win this one to force a winner take all.
Oh, that is such a good flop.
Hissner knocks them both in. That's why that shot was so good. Clemmer bounces right around it.
And now this could be for the win.
And it goes off the back.
He got excited. Will Hissner go for an airmail drag? No, he's going to go with a slide. And just to concede a single point, make it 18.
This one almost came to an end in a hurry. And now Clemmer, 3 points away. Boy, Duncan quickly becoming a crowd favorite here in Rock Hill.
Well, you know where he's from. He lives less than 20 minutes from this arena, which is, he is a hometown hero. Last year it was Jordan Kimbrell that had the breakout. This year it appears to be Duncan Clemmer. Will he go for an airmail here to possibly drag and put all the pressure on Adam Hissner? He's going up.
Too strong, one hopper off the back.
Now what will Hissner go here? Will he go airmail? No, he's going hard push.
Checks up and the other one sticks on the front side. Just wouldn't go. 18-11. And Hissner now with the honors. Ooh, a little bit to the right.
And it's not going to be a dagger, but that's at least to put him on 20. You just can't miss again.
Boy, that bag is so beautiful to watch.
Oh, now that could be a dagger.
Just on the edge, he's going to have a chance with this last bag. Oh, well, nope, now just a chance for two, and it comes back in. So 20-11, Clemmer now 1 point away.
20-11, watch time.
Adam Hissner, again, one of the blue bloods in this sport, top 25 in the world, having a terrific season. And Clemmer trying to send him home here in the singles competition.
One more point. Flop. Here comes a push. Hit that left bag. Now, if he can push them all, he can guarantee a win if he puts all these bags in. Four bagger wins it for Clemmer, but he gets pushed outright. He stayed on sticky side, which was an interesting call there. I'm surprised he didn't flip it over.
Still a lot of pressure here on Hissner, though, right?
This bag has got to be in.
On the way, and it is in. So a wash. We'll go to another round. Clemmer can't get the bags out of the hole fast enough right now.
Yeah, I mean, he is pure adrenaline running through that guy's veins right now.
1 point away. First one's good. Hissner cuts right around it. Nice shot. And the push is good. A lot of pressure here for Hissner.
Gotta be in again.
In, and Hissner is also right up the middle. And well, sigh of relief there for Adam Hissner. And back down to the other end. Hissner led 4-0, and it's been Clemmer ever since.
Be it.
Yeah, a little bit too short on that block, perhaps.
Hissner gonna go after it.
Gets them both. What a shot.
Gosh.
And Clemmer with the answer. Comes down to the final bag here
there.
For both. It's in.
Gotta be in.
And it is again. Back and forth. Down and back we go.
This is just unbelievable.
Hissner just hanging on.
He will not go away.
Oh, again, a little short and left. Clemmer kind of gets in his way a little bit.
He just rolls so good.
And again, down to the final bags.
Gotta be in.
It is a game trade.
This is outrageous right now.
Hissner, one of the top players in the game, taking on Duncan Clemmer on the biggest stage of his career.
Three straight double four baggers, four straight washes. And that is short.
Get it. Ah.
Clemmer had a tough time rolling over it.
Oh, no.
And now Hissner off the back of the board.
Get
Clemmer with the chance, rolls it in.
And now Hissner has to get this bag. He will not get it. So Clemmer really just needs to be on the board, and now there has to be some trickery and magic going on here. Duncan Clemmer advances to his first ever pro singles playoff here at the World Championships.
Come here, baby. Let me see you. Yes, sir.
The local product from here in nearby Rock Hill, South Carolina, with a huge win, biggest win of his career over Adam Hissner.
What a performance. Duncan Clemmer.
Did it, come on.
What a scene.
Yes, sir, that's right.
I don't care what sport it is. It matters. What a win for Duncan Clemmer. We'll see him again here in Rock Hill.
Keep going, baby.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Rock Hill, South Carolina. Great look of the main broadcast court here inside the Rock Hill Sports and Event Center alongside Trey Ryder. I'm Jeff McCarriger. Thanks for joining us tonight here in the 2021 ACL World Championships, the biggest week of the year in this sport. And again, we've gone from 256 players all the way down to the final eight. Duncan Clemmer and Trey Birchfield both into that final four, looking for two more to join them into the final four here for the Singles World Championship that we'll have broadcast later on this weekend.
Yes, and this is going to be an epic matchup right here. Eric Davis, the push, roll, flop, crazy shot. Think of something I've never seen before. Master versus the blind squirrel, Ryan Windsor, coming off of that huge win at the final chase.
There's Trey Birchfield, able to just fend off a pesky Jordan Power, who played so well here tonight. But number two in the world, Trey Birchfield, is into the final four.
Now, the reason Trey Birchfield is so invested, of course, he wants to see who's going to make the playoff with him. But because of Damon Dennis's finish and Trey Birchfield getting a bracket win here, guaranteeing at least 400 points, he is going to become the man of the year if he outfinishes Ryan Windsor. So if Eric Davis wins this, Trey Birchfield will finish the ACL season, regardless of how Saturday plays out, as the number one player in the world.
Windsor trying to go for a hard liner to push some in, and too short, clips the front of the board. And now Eric Davis trying to roll it in, just sticks on top of Windsor's bag. And Windsor somehow gets those to fall.
Wow, that was a big push right there by Ryan Windsor. He'll steal a couple.
Ryan, a big push there. Give him 2 points. 2-0.
Man, what a shot. Those bags just stick up on top of each other and then fall.
They just sandwiched on top. And then both fell back in.
Now, again, this is a bracket final again, like we just saw. So the winner of this is into the pro singles playoff, but Eric Davis is undefeated. He came through the winner's bracket. So if he were to win this first game, it's over. If Ryan Windsor wins the first game, then it will go to a winner take all game two.
Really 2-0 lead here for Ryan Windsor. There you see him on the left. Eric Davis on the right. Eric Davis, again, another one of the great young players, just 17 years old, out of East Davidson High School, right up the road in Thomasville, North Carolina, just north of Charlotte.
And a double four bagger.
Eric Davis, national doubles champion with Brett Guy in Wichita earlier this season. Boy, that was a fun one to watch. It was Eric Davis and Brett Guy. And in the finals in Wichita, they had to take on Matt Guy, Brett's dad, and Jamie Graham. And the youngsters able to get a big win.
Oh, Windsor smartly takes away that push opportunity for Eric Davis.
Trying to go for that backside airmail. Sticks, and Davis, just a laser.
How? That's, I just don't understand how he continues to do these type of shots.
I don't know how he just did that and get around his own bag.
Right.
Windsor's drops, so he gets the
he
four back.
He rolls over.
And Davis, that, I mean, that's an easy
Jeff,
shot for Eric
come
Davis.
Come on, Jeff. Jeff. What just happened? If you told me that round after the first two bags was going to end in a double four-bagger, I would have laughed in your face. That was absolutely ridiculous.
Davis, on the replay, it looked like Davis threw his bag so hard and so low that it actually clipped and skipped underneath the corner of his own bag. Unreal. It's like he went underneath it.
Yeah, I don't have words to describe that last round.
And Eric Davis just flips it in. Man, is this kid good.
Put Eric on the
Meanwhile, you got Ryan Windsor, who, after
starting off the year pretty quiet, actually, for being the number four player in the world. All of a sudden got that pro singles championship at Valley Forge in the final chase. And, you know, really the most impressive stat on Ryan Windsor, Troy, correct me if I'm wrong on this, but with that win at Valley Forge in the final chase, I think Ryan now has what? Won a national tournament in four of the last 5 years.
That is correct. That is correct.
At 23 years old. So, I mean, that you know, we talk about guys who have multiple wins on the year, but to win a national event, which in cornhole is the equivalent of a major tournament, that kind of puts it into perspective. Four in the last 5 years, just 23 years old.
You know, it's funny, Jeff, I don't even know why we bothered miking up these two, because I don't think they will say a single word.
Yeah, we could have saved some time on that one.
Oh,
nice
gosh.
Shot. And Davis, a little bit to the right.
I think I'm done telling you bags are out of play for Eric Davis.
Oh, if he just had one more left, he could probably get them all.
Right, right. I mean, I don't know. He's starting to invent things, yeah. So I just don't.
Windsor helps him out a little bit.
Still going to get two.
Yeah, Brian's in there, make it four
but,
two.
Yeah. Eric Davis is just outrageous.
Windsor, first bag is in. Ryan Windsor out of the booming metropolis of Cuba, Illinois. Population 1,304.
Huge city.
Got a chance to talk to him about it, though, from Valley Forge. And
watch how easy this is for Eric Davis. Watch this. That was mean. I jinxed him.
Ryan is so proud of his hometown. Just loves everybody there. Obviously, they all support him and love watching him. Cuba, Illinois. I can't remember the name of the place, the establishment where they all go, but I think there's a place they all kind of gather to watch him. Maybe we need to take the tour to Cuba, Illinois one of these years. That'd be fun. Again, Windsor just 23 years old. The old man here on the court.
That is true. It is ridiculous to think about, but it is true. Oh, hit the dead spot.
Second time he's done that, just a little short.
That's the thing about playing against Eric Davis. You gotta watch your pace of play, because he is just gonna fire. That's his play style. And although Ryan Windsor doesn't need to be someone that takes a long time between throws, at the same time, you need a little bit of a break.
Windsor will try to collect that, does. Chance for a couple and gets it. Early little lead change here, 6-5 Ryan Windsor.
6-5.
Boy, just sit back, relax, and enjoy this one.
6-5.
That's interesting. We talked earlier about a guy like Jordan Power, who practices basically 5 to 7 days a week and practices strategy by literally placing bags in different, you know, spots on the board. Then you get a guy like Eric Davis, and had a chance to talk to him, and he said, you know, he really doesn't practice. He just plays a lot. He just tries to play in every tournament he can get into.
Both players go for the airmail, both miss, and now does. No. No, he's not.
Can you roll over the top of that entire
pile?
No,
I thought he was stepping back to try to push everything in. Is he still trying to do, or no, he's trying to roll, I think. I don't even know. I'm tired of, you know, it's like stupid of me to even start trying to predict these shots, because he just invents stuff.
Looked like he was trying to roll that one, but that pile was huge in front of the hole. So stays 6-5. So interesting. Eric just makes it look so easy. He just flips it up there. There it is. Rolls it on top of the pile again. All right, can you throw a laser and clip that bag and put them both in?
He almost did. He almost did. I guess that's what we need to do, Jeff. We just need to think of the most creative way to get bags in the hole, and that's what Eric Davis is going to do.
Flops it.
Were you thinking of a rolling laser right there? Because that's what was just thrown.
Just wheels it right in. Another wash, and it'll stay a one-point match. Again, Eric Davis on the right. Ryan Windsor on the left. As Trey was saying a few moments ago, Ryan would have to win twice in this scenario to advance. Trey Birchfield is in. Duncan Klemmer is in to the final four. Oh, what a collect. Grabs it, pulled them both down, and he'll get two.
Give Ryan two.
8-5. This game still, I don't know what to think of it.
I know, I'm with you.
You know, I don't. I'm still, both have been good.
Mm-hmm.
Neither has been exceptional, and you just don't know if it's going to stay like that the entire time, if someone's going to really step up their game and get in a zone, if someone's just going to kind of lose focus. It's just tough to tell.
Yeah, it's just a totally different game, right? Because if you think back to Greg Geary and Jordan Power, I mean, it was just one after another after another. I mean, just the string of four baggers, right? Just going hole for hole. Whereas these two guys, just totally different. Like, they're okay making the board just totally messy.
That's a wash.
And another wash. If you missed it, earlier tonight, Jordan Power, who ended up being eliminated, but not before he put on a show against Greg Geary. He hit 30 straight bags in the hole, one away from the record, or one away from tying the record, I should say. Eric Davis.
Was that a bar of soap?
Oh, did it push Windsor's over the hole?
I'm pretty sure we just saw a bar of soap on TV. I'm pretty sure that's what we just saw.
And
give me that.
Davis.
Give me that.
He'll get two here to make it 8-7.
Big four-bagger there for Eric. 8-7.
Yeah, did he skip underneath that bag and then flop Windsor's
sure
over the hole?
I'm pretty sure he just pushed Ryan Windsor's off to the back side of the hole. Oh, my gosh, Eric Davis.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. Just a total different game than what we saw earlier tonight. Goes again hard at it.
Ooh, that was a laser, yeah. Jeff.
One went off the back, though. And now Ryan will try to grab this one. Pull it down, and he does. Nice shot.
Going to be a single point. 9-7 now.
9-7.
Well, the largest lead so far in this one was 3 just a moment ago. Windsor on top 8-5, so it's been 3 or less the whole way so far. I mean, I sit here and I'd like to think that I wouldn't like to say, but you know, I think in my mind that bag's out of play for Davis.
Yeah, that's out of play. I can confidently say that. I'm not going to say that one's out of play. Now, normally 95% of players is out of play, but, you know, before you know it, Eric Davis is going to try some type of shot where it, like, jumps up into the lighting rig that we got up here, and then it falls on the backside and actually comes at a backward angle.
Yeah.
He's just going to start, like, it's going to be a boomerang. He's going to put some type of spin on it. It's going to, you know, travel back. I mean, I don't know.
Like Larry Bird in the game of horse. Well, all of a sudden, from 9-7 to 13-7.
Oh, my gosh. That
checks
was
up.
Nasty roll. Nasty push. Those are all going in. This is going to be a four spot for Dave. Oh, this might be 6. Can he hit the airman? Oh, he's going push.
And I can't tell if they're still moving or not.
Doesn't look like they're moving. Yeah, it's going to be 2 points for Davis. 13-9 is what it should be. That's correct.
Again, Ryan Windsor in a must-win situation to force an all or nothing as that one misses to the right. And now Windsor misses. Are both those still in play, though?
The one on the left is. The one on the right.
Oh, trouble now. Windsor goes in.
Will he go after it with an airmail? He's going. There you go.
And Windsor, though, still slides it up the middle. So plus round here for Ryan Windsor. Makes it 15-9.
Brian, too, make it 15-9.
What a beautiful collect.
And Davis again to the left. Windsor right up the middle. Four bagger for Windsor. Eric Davis, a little frustration in that one, throws in the airmail. Yeah. But still gives up four to make it 19-9.
Yeah, and he had to have that bag in the hole. Chose to go after it with an airmail, but you can tell he's frustrated.
Well, he obviously knows in the back of his head that he can allow this one to slip away.
There's no emotion from Eric Davis. What you're seeing from Eric Davis is the equivalent of someone screaming, a normal person just screaming in frustration. If you can hear him breathe loudly, he's frustrated.
All right, so here's my question, though, Trey. Do you think he goes to it too much with the roll? I mean, at some point, shouldn't you just start putting some more in the hole?
Is he going to try to borrow soap this whole thing off?
Yes.
Oh, and he took one. Oh, and that's actually, I forgot one fell in the hole, so that's going to do it on that first game. So Ryan Windsor going to take game one. We go immediately into a game two.
So a must-have for Ryan Windsor, and he gets it. So on to the winner take all. But, yeah, I mean, would you like to see?
Tails.
They're going to do a coin flip here real quick. Eric Davis wins it, and he's going to choose to stay on the same side. So, again, back to my point, Trey, do you want to see Eric just slide some more shots in instead of getting maybe too creative, too clever?
He's good enough to do it.
Yeah.
I mean,
okay.
It's
like that.
It's tough.
I guess a lot of it depends on what, you know, your opponent gives you, too.
In the words of his one of his sponsors, Fire Cornhole and Jason McCannon, Eric Davis can be the best player in the world as long as he doesn't get bored. And bored is not the best use of the word. I mean, he's actually not getting bored, but it's, does he have the patience sometimes to throw 16 bags in a row?
Right.
Or is he the type of person that needs to have a roll and a flop and a big push and everything?
To keep his interest. What a shot by Windsor. Literally a curveball right around it. Almost did it again.
Windsor go with an airmail, trying to oh, and they are hanging up.
It sticks, so yeah, it's just not going to go. They grab it. So Eric Davis with a couple of points to make it 4-0 early on here. Again, the winner of this match will advance into the final four to join Duncan Clemmer and Trey Birchfields. That one rolls off to the right. And right up the middle. Windsor for the wash gets it.
That's a one.
Four nothing. Trey Birchfield earlier tonight with an impressive win over Jordan Power, who made a great run this week. And then Adam Hissner back under the lights as he always seems to be here in 2021, but knocked off by Duncan Klemmer, 32 ranked player in the world.
And now what happens here? What does Eric Davis decide to do? My gut is he's going to throw it as hard as he can at the pile. Hey, that's it works. Airmail drag hero get a point. Oh, he's not even going for an airmail. He hopes it would fall, and it did not. Eric Davis, another point.
5-0.
5-0, Davis.
This may seem like a strange analogy, but watching Eric Davis, it's almost like watching a game of like Jenga, where he's like trying to pull out the piece on the bottom.
Right, that's exactly what he's trying to do.
And letting the pile fall over the top. That's what he does. He just goes low and hard at it with these line drives and gets everything else to flop in. Too strong.
Ooh.
See, the player is looking to their left. There is a monitor. They see the same view that you're looking at right now.
He went for a hard push as well, and now we'll, I'm assuming Windsor will just try to take these both. And he does. Wow.
All right, so that's a good example there, Trey. Like, would you rather have seen Eric Davis go for maybe a short airmail to try and drag that other one in? Or?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's.
I feel like he relies.
If he tries eight of those shots, you know, that's and he hits six or seven of them, that's like the eighth that you kind of want to roll that one back.
Because I feel like that, I mean, he has such a great, low, hard, laser push, but it's kind of seems like an all or nothing. Because if it's not right on target, that thing just zips off the back.
Oh, what a roll by Ryan Windsor. Now a drag has to be hit here just to limit it to one.
And again, that's exactly what I'm talking about right there, Trey. I mean, you know better than I do.
No, I think that one, he actually went for a cut push, which I don't hate. Now, this is a great roll by Windsor. Davis just thought he could get around that bag. And so in that particular instance, I don't classify that as the same as the other round. He just... That was an either or. He just went with the other option.
Players speeding through this round. Windsor trying to sneak around it. Checks up too short for the third time this match.
Don't get bunched up on the left side.
Goes off the back of the board.
That's what you got to be careful of when you try to hit that bag. When you're on the right, you're trying to, and you're right-handed, and you're trying to collect a bag on the left side, two things happen a lot. One, that, or two, you hit it too square, and you both your bags bunch up on that left side. You really have to focus on being in the hole first.
Oh, again, just wheels it up the board and in.
Man, these guys are just showing off now. Oh, my God.
So, a little slider with a little roll action to it.
Man, that last bag, that bag was almost vertical in the air when Eric Davis let go of that. And that thing kind of, like, tumbled.
17 years old. 9-5, Windsor with the lead. If you're just tuning in, Ryan Windsor, they're in the white Bush's Beans jersey. And Eric Davis on the left.
I think this becomes an airmail game. Well, I was just going to say, Windsor may step out because he does have a small angle.
Now a mess in front of the hole.
Now, if Eric Davis goes for the push here, then that's overthinking it.
Oh, he goes way up top and hits the airmail. Oh, my gosh.
That was Jeff. He threw that thing above the lighting.
I was going to say, how high are the truss here? That was at least as high as the truss.
I It's almost frustrating calling an Eric Davis game because I can't give you analysis.
Goes for it again, but takes in one of Windsor's with it.
Dude, I mean, look at this.
It's off the monitor.
You can't. We can't get a shot of it.
No.
You can't physically get a shot of that. Oh, unbelievable.
There's a look at the truss, kind of the scaffolding looking that you see that holds all the lights. I want to say it's 15 feet, Trey, but I can't remember. I know they've told us before, but man, you're talking about an airmail.
That's an airmail. Yeah.
Indeed. Now here you push him in. Ah, misses to the right.
Ooh, and now Windsor, how aggressive do you want to be, though? You want to skip. He's going to hit here and then kind of skip over. Okay, that's fine. You'll take that. You'll take your two. I'm okay playing conservative there.
11-7, Windsor.
You're Brian, two, make it 11-7.
A little bit short right.
Oh, and this is going to be interesting. You want to flop? He wants to be on top of Windsor's bag right there. Oh, he tried. He tried that bar of soap. He tried to push the bag sitting in front of the hole and have it skip way off the back and then he go in. That's what he tried to do. Yeah. He just didn't execute it.
And that's what I'm talking about. As much as I love that shot, I think you can almost like fall in love with it too much because it's all or nothing.
And I think we need to come up with a new name for it because there's nothing intuitive about seeing the bar soap.
Yeah.
I just heard it because that's what everybody calls it. So we're gonna. That's the next thing is name it. Name that shot.
Well, I threw my name out there. I wanted to call it the Evel Knievel, but I think I'm too old. I think everyone else is like, who's Evel Knievel? I tried, David. You think Eric Davis knows who Evel Knievel is?
Ooh, well, this is. Now, do you go airmail? Is a question.
He's trying it. Too strong.
Now, if you're Windsor, you're like, I'll lay on the board. Easy.
Whoa.
Easy. Gonna be three more points.
Yeah, Ryan,
quickly
there.
Grab those bags out of the
14
hole.
To eight.
14-8, Ryan Windsor. Windsor. Number four player in the world. We've seen number one go down, Jamie Graham. Cody Henderson also out. Number three player in the world. Number two is still alive, Trey Birchfield, and number four is hanging on here. Nice shot by Eric. And now Davis trying to get some points back.
What's 14-10. What's interesting is if Ryan Windsor makes this playoff, right, they will be the top two seeds, which means they won't play each other in the first round. Okay? And if Ryan Windsor and Trey Birchfield were to meet in the finals, that finals match is worth 10 points. And the difference between them is 10 points. So Trey Birchfield, if he wins, he becomes the man of the year. If actually Ryan Windsor wins, we have a tie.
You see the point standings? Oh, airmail clean through.
Here's a situation where I think it's better if you just lay. Yeah. There's no benefit to airmail. Now, maybe he was trying a roll there, and a roll's safer if you just kind of sneak in the front. That's fine. But an airmail does you no good because you're going to drag Davis's bag.
Right.
And if you drag Davis's bag, you get nothing.
14-10. Eric Davis came in with the advantage. Ryan Windsor was going to have to double dip Eric Davis and win twice. Windsor's already won the first, and now leading here in the Second matchup.
Oh, Davis is in trouble here.
Yeah, that hole is blocked.
Well, that's good. That's a good recovery. But now Windsor's going to have two opportunities in an airmail. There's one.
Boy, there's
I know Davis wants to do something with this, but I really think the best thing here is just to lay up or roll on top of it.
Yeah, I was going to say, now here's where I would hit the roller. And again, Trey.
I don't know. I don't understand that shot selection.
I don't either.
He got away with it.
Yeah. If I had the ability to roll like he would, it's just such a higher percentage shot, right? Because best case scenario, it rolls over the pile and just sneaks in that little edge on the backside.
Worst case scenario, just
sits on top.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep. Still 14-10. Or sorry, making 14-12 rather. A couple points there for Eric Davis on that round. But and again, you know, this is interesting. This is one of those matchups where it feels like Ryan Windsor has been had the advantage. But it's only a 2 points game coming into this round.
Now 3 point
game. And that make it to the three, yeah.
Give Ryan one, make it 15-12.
15-12. Ryan Windsor 6 points away. Oh, what a roll. Might have ourselves a roll off here. There's another by Windsor. Oh, and that's as good as it gets.
Now,
man,
if he touches the pile, they're all going to go in. Just trying to gently put it on the board, and he does.
And that looks like it's going to be a 4 point round for, Ryan Windsor. Going to put him on 19.
Yep, Windsor saying plus four. So 19-12. Windsor now 2 points away.
Yep.
Wait a second. So here in the arena it's saying 17-12, but.
Yeah, we got 19. 19 is the right thing. Our broadcast court official Josh Keck didn't see the other bag in, but no harm, no foul. We're at 19-12.
So again, Windsor 2 points away from.
And that bag is out of play, and now the words everybody wants to hear, four-bagger wins it by Ryan Windsor.
Two are short as Windsor flops over the top of it. Front one, Davis able to roll it in. And this one off to the left. And so what, Eric's got to put this in, right?
You got to put this in without taking Windsor's, and that is going to do it. Ryan Windsor off to the pro singles playoff.
Ryan Windsor double dips Eric Davis.
The number one seed, the man of the year trophy up for grabs between Ryan Windsor and Trey Birchfield, as well as a world championship title.
Eric Davis so good today here in Rock Hill, but Ryan Windsor out of the loser's bracket comes through and knocks off Davis twice to advance.
Try Bush's Sweet Heat baked beans with that pop of jalapeno heat. And boom, your regular old Thursday night is a jalapeno night. Bush's makes any night beautiful.
And spicy.
At Johnsonville, we've often wondered, how can burgers and dogs be our national tradition when you can't even spell sausage without USA? Exercise your right to mix it up and throw on some Johnsonville sausage, because freedom is delicious. Your backyard deserves the best. For a limited time, buy Johnsonville sausage or Bush's baked beans for a chance to win a Pit Boss grill, professional cornhole boards, and sausage and beans for a year. Learn more at bestofthebackyard.com.
AllCornhole.com has the largest online selection of cornhole bags for players of all levels. Through years of research and development, AllCornhole.com has the perfect bags for even pro-level players. With over 4 unique series to choose from, including Game Changers, All Slides, Slide Rights, and Steadies, you'll be sure to find the right bags to dominate the competition. Whether you're looking for bags for family gatherings, competitive league night, or the pro circuit, go to allcornhole.com to get the perfect boards and bags for you.
In this house, we believe anyone can play and anyone can win. Where others have dropped the ball, the American Cornhole League has stepped up to the plate. Carefully crafted and trusted by players everywhere, we've set the standard for cornhole equipment worldwide. Branded with ACL Pro, ACL Competitive, and ACL Recreation stamps, look for our seal of approval to know you're making the right choice. Play like a pro with officially licensed American Cornhole League boards and bags from approved manufacturers. Visit our website to find your new game day gear.
They say there's no such thing as a free lunch, but there is at DraftKings. You can compete for thousands in prizes in our free-to-play pools without spending a dime. Put your knowledge to the test by answering questions about specific games or events. The more you pick right, the better your shot to win and chow down on a cash casserole. Casserole. Download the DraftKings app now. Enter with the promo code, play free for thousands, and make it rain.
Dustin Poirier wanted a better life, built it. Wanted respect, earned it. Wanted a title, won it. Decided to change the world, doing it. You know how my man keeps accomplishing everything he sets out to do? He believes that he can. Guaranteed Rate believes in your dreams. That's why we treat everyone like we treat our own family and work extra hard to get you the lowest low rate possible. Because if you believe, you will.
Those beautiful Bush's baked beans. The delicious center of picnic table gravity that keeps the whole great barbecue universe spinning. Bush's makes the cookout beautiful.
From 256 players, trying to get all the way down to the final four. We have three of the final four in. One more match to decide who is going to join Trey Birchfield and Duncan Clemmer and Ryan Windsor. And as we look at the updated brackets, last matchup, Cheyenne Renner. What a day she's had against Eddie Grindersleeve. You see Duncan Clemmer, the win over Adam Hissner. Trey Birchfield advances. Ryan Windsor double dipping Eric Davis to advance in the final four. So it comes down to this. And Trey, you know exactly, you've been watching her all day, what kind of day Cheyenne Renner's had. There you see her on the right.
She's been white hot, white hot. I would say probably the best player I've seen all day, and that says a lot. But the problem is she's been she hasn't played a real game in almost 3 hours.
Right.
So I don't know what to expect here. Now, this is another bracket final. Cheyenne Renner is undefeated. So Eddie Grindersleeve will have to win twice.
And we are ready for our last matchup to decide who will be the final player into the final four. Grindersleeve with the honors. Cheyenne Renner out of DeLand, Florida. An incredible year. Eddie Grindersleeve from Austin, Texas.
Just a couple weeks after Cameron Belvin became the first person to ever win a pro doubles event at the shootout. First ever female player to win a pro doubles event. Cheyenne Renner can be the first ever person to advance to a pro singles playoff. The first ever female to do it. Cameron Belvin, her again, came close to it in February of this year at the 2021 kickoff battle, but no female in a pro division event that includes both men and women has ever made a Final Four, and Cheyenne Renner has a chance to do it. There's only three events that Cheyenne Renner, she has played in women's singles. She has made the finals, waiting to play Connie Altais in the finals on Saturday. She has played co-ed doubles with Matt Guy. She is waiting to play in the finals for that on Saturday at 1 p.m.
Oh, and a tough luck shot there as it just sticks on top of the hole.
And she has played in women's doubles with Sarah Cassidy. She is in the finals, waiting to play in that on Sunday. 3-for-3 on finals appearances and now looking to make history as a female player.
Big early round for Eddie Grindersleeve. And a 4-0 lead.
Renner hit 31 bags in a row to beat Cody Henderson earlier. And in one of her games yesterday, in women's singles, hit 60 of 64.
And a chance to get a couple right back here. She does to make it 4-2. Well, Eddie off to a good start here. He's hit 11 of his first 12. But giving up a couple points there to make it 4-2.
Oh, and by the way, Cheyenne Renner, with her performance today, has also clinched the 2021 Woman of the Year Award as the number one ranked female player in the world.
It's a big week.
She's good.
Bag a little short and left here for Grindersleeve. And now to the right as Cheyenne goes right down the middle. And a chance at a big round. Yeah, she's going to pick up 4 points. So just like that, Renner's right back, and she's going to take the lead. Renner.
Cheyenne Renner throwing those pink Ultra Vipers. That's her signature bag. Eddie Grindersleeve throwing those BG Wizards.
And again, no wiggle room at all here for Eddie Grindersleeve. Got to win this one to try and force a winner take all. Eddie's done this on the big stage before. We saw him get a big win in his home state of Texas, a pro qualifier last year in Galveston, Texas. But a tall order here against Cheyenne Renner.
That bag is a little short. Now will Grindersleeve try to lay up behind or try to go through it? I'm going to go around it, and I'm going to get 2 points.
Ties it up at six. Watch this.
Eddie Grindersleeve, come on. Wow, what a shot.
Didn't even touch it. Well, for Cheyenne Renner, again, this is just a few of the highlights this year here in 2021. Doubles champion with Sarah Cassidy at the first national in Winter Haven, Florida. Winner of women's singles, she beat Rosie Streaker, the third pro shootout in Nashville. Doubles champion with Sarah Cassidy again at the third national year in Las Vegas. Lost in the finals of the women's doubles at Valley Forge and won the pro invitational championship with Ryan Smith up in Valley Forge.
And then did that shot. And then collects, pushes a bag. She says, Eddie Grindersleeve, I see your sneak around on the last round, and I one up you a push sneak around to get around your bag.
What a shot. And didn't take Grindersleeve's with it. And now 8-6 Cheyenne. So again, those are just a few of the 2021 highlights, not to mention everything that Trey just said that she's done this week. What a year. Eddie trying to bring that back into play. Nice bag. Cheyenne blocks in behind it.
Got to be an airmail drag. And that's exactly what Cheyenne Renner wanted.
Perfect
exactly.
Bag.
A perfect block. You force the airmail and you say, fine, Eddie. Knock two in. That's fine. But you're going to trampoline off if you're going to do that, and I'm going to steal a point. That is perfect execution.
Renner now with a 3-point lead. Well, Trey, I guess I would say at this point she's probably warmed up again, right? I mean,
yes.
Because that was one of the things you worried about, that she had not
worried,
played in
yes.
3 hours.
Now, I've been most impressed so far by both Duncan Clemmer and Cheyenne Renner.
Yeah.
Duncan Clemmer for being his first time and sitting for a while, but Cheyenne Renner especially for sitting the longest out of anybody. And again, I don't know if she was actually sitting. She very well could have been warming up. Oh my gosh, Eddie.
Shot. Just sneaks around it again. A little backdoor slider action.
He's showing off here on these fourth bags. I thought there was no way this time he was getting in, but he just sneaks around.
Love it. Stays 9-6. Runner right in front of the hole with the V block. See if she can push it through now, and she does.
Maybe
very well
executed.
A little
bit of a step out here by Grindersley. Well, it feels like he doesn't have to.
Oh, nice shot to bring it back in. That was a big time play by Grindersleeve, and now to finish it off, he does. That third shot was huge. So impressive. It seemed like that bag might have been out of play. But he brought it back in near the red zone and then cleaned it up. Well done. I think that's one of my favorite strategies, I think, to watch is just that V block in front of the hole.
Yeah.
And then force your opponent to deflect off from left to right, and then you just clean it up and push right through.
Yep.
I love that.
Yeah, it works. That's why they throw it.
Yeah.
Cheyenne, stay skinny and get around.
Every
she cannot. In for two for Grindersleeve.
Just short. Jeez, it's going to stay 9-6. So close. All right, Trey, this may be a dumb question. At this point in the day, what made me think about this is that both players squatting all the way down to pick up the bags. At some point in the day, in a long day like this, 256 players going all the way down to eight to the final four, does it ever get tiring on your knees? Up and down, down and back? All
day, all
night? I
think they're exhausted, but at the same time.
Not at this point.
There's so much adrenaline right now with so much on the line.
Yeah.
It does fall now. Goal posts in for a wash.
Still 9-6.
What a monumental win this would be for females in the sport.
Yeah, if for some reason you're just tuning in, Trey mentioned it moments ago, but again, Cheyenne Renner right there trying to become the first woman ever here in a pro singles event to get into the final four.
Guaranteed another point. Will it be more? It will not. It'll be a single point, but she gets to double digits. She's now 11 points away.
Make it 10-6.
Cheyenne's dad actually got her into the game when she was just a sophomore in high school. Took her to some tournaments with him, and she just kind of fell in love. Loved the competition.
And here's the thing. If you put her against probably 80% of the pros in here, and this crowd is going wild every time she throws a four-bagger, the problem is you pinned her up against one of the most likable pros in the entire division in Eddie Grindersleeve. And so everybody is somewhat conflicted just because Eddie has been such a stand-up pro and such a great ambassador for the game.
Well, and you and I were just talking about the similar dynamic in Florida way back earlier this season when Cameron Belbin was trying to do the same thing, and she ran into Damon Dennis.
Right.
Another
right.
favorite.
Again, it's
and
like,
all of a sudden, Damon Dennis is the bad guy.
Right.
He's never the bad guy. Eddie just touches him and they all drop. Big bag here for Renner. Pushes them both
she gets
in. Beautiful.
Them both. That sits her plus two right now. In for two.
And off the back of the board. Wow. Frustrated with herself.
You have Eddie one there.
So Eddie picks up one instead of what could have been plus two for Renner. So now a 1 point match.
This just feels like it's going to go down to the wire, Jeff.
Yeah. Again, keep in mind, Grindersleeve, no wiggle room whatsoever. He has to win this match to force a winner take all.
Oh, and this looks like a big five spot coming.
Yeah,
got to be in just to limit it to five.
Can she pull that other bag in. Almost did it, but instead it's going to be a big round here for Grindersleeve, as that one just will not fall through. And now Eddie with a four-point lead.
Eddie Grindersleeve of 14-10.
Huge momentum swing here. Midway through. And it was just a minute ago you were talking about Cheyenne getting to double digits.
Will she go up? No, she's going to try to go through. Oh, behind. Now becomes an airmail game. Who can airmail best? Eddie going up. He hits it. Can Cheyenne answer?
Grindersleeve hits it clean, and Cheyenne misses a one-hopper off to the left. And now 17-10. All of a sudden, Eddie Grindersleeve, 4 points away from forcing a winner-take-all for the last slot in the Final Four.
Eddie Grindersleeve, 4 points away from forcing a winner-take-all game two. He has been lights out.
Try to put all four in. He does. Puts the pressure back on Cheyenne. And able to slide it through. Stay 17-10. Well, Cheyenne has made no secrets about it. Her and I have talked about it several times. I mean, cornhole is a complete mental challenge for her. As we have chronicled, there is no doubt that she has the skills physically. And she's the first one to admit it's just all mental.
This is getting unbelievable. These two. I mean, another. This has the similar feeling to when I was watching Cody Henderson and Cheyenne Renner go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth near the end of their game. I mean, it was 20-20, and they washed with double four baggers four times in a row. I mean, is that the first glimpse? Nope.
Cheyenne takes them all in. As that's going to be too far out of play, and now Cheyenne misses to the left. That opens up the hole a little bit. Can she grab that one? Tried to do it, but just one
tries.
Another wash. It'll stay 17-10. Grindersleeve on top. And Eddie from Austin, Texas. We got a chance to go to Austin earlier this season on the Pro Shootout Series.
Man. Well, that's a good bag. Oh, and that's going to be an opportunity to steal. That feels like a stolen point, couple points if you're Cheyenne Renner. A little bit of a break and serve. 17-12.
5 point difference. There's that block again in front. Grindersleeve goes directly in behind her.
And Renner behind that.
Grindersleeve has been so good with his airmail. And Renner with the answer. Two bags left here for Eddie. Hits another one. And Cheyenne too short. And now Eddie's got one right in front of the hole.
If he brings this in, he will win game one, force a game two.
It's on the way, goes low at it, hits one in, but the other one just hangs in the red zone.
Going to be sitting on 20.
20 to
So now Eddie 1 point away from forcing a winner take all. Final slot up for grabs in the final four for the Pro Singles World Championship. Opportunity here for Cheyenne. Might be able to get two back. The thing is that, you know, if you're Cheyenne right now, you're hoping for maybe 4 or 5 points, but Eddie has been so consistent. It's going to be tough to get a 4 or 5 point round off him. She'll pick up two there.
But she needs it.
Yeah.
She needed that right there. She got it. And now she will have first back for the rest of this game. So, I mean, that's the small glimmer right there. You got to score 7 straight.
Nice shot by Eddie. Just goes right around it. Sneak around it,
Will he go for a sneak around airmail or something for the win?
It looked like he was trying to cut it around from right to left, but ended up grabbing her bag.
That was the shot he was hitting at the beginning of the game.
Didn't it look like the way he angled it? He was trying to maybe.
Right,
do
he
a
was. He absolutely was.
20-14. Straight for both players. Four bagger for Renner. And Grindersleeve with the answer. Another double four bagger.
Another double four bagger wash.
Man.
Stays 20-14.
Eddie Grindersleeve. I've seen Eddie Grindersleeve be really, really good before. This is the best I've ever seen him. He is locked in.
I'm kind of feeling like when we watch the Philip Hayden-Damon Dennis matchup. You know, because we know Damon's so good and so consistent, and when you're playing against Damon Dennis, you really have to be almost perfect, and you just have to wait Damon out just for him to make a mistake. And I feel that's like what Eddie's had to do, because Cheyenne's been so good. He's just had to wait for a mistake and just be so consistent, and that's what he's been able to do. Take advantage of small windows.
I mean, This is outrageous right now.
Still a 6-point game. Go ahead. Neither one wants to give up an inch right now.
Oh, and that could be it right there.
Let's see. Eddie a little bit to the right. Oh, and now it's a mess.
And that's as good as it gets. Cheyenne needs to be here, unfortunately. Oh, and now in for the win.
And Eddie gets one, but not the other.
It's good enough for the win.
Yep, still it's going to pick up enough to put him over the edge. So Eddie Grindersleeve wins the first one, and now we are on to the winner-take-all matchup.
All right, good luck.
Hey, you too.
Ladies and gentlemen, for the final time this evening.
You can feel the pressure.
These bags are
as Eddie Grindersleeve said to Cheyenne Renner, you too. Again, if you're just tuning in, Cheyenne Renner trying to become the first female pro player to advance into the pro singles final four.
And she's looking really good in position right now for at least a couple.
Try to go up the middle here.
Now, Eddie Grindersleeve's got to go in just to limit it to 3.
And he does. So a 3-0 lead here for Cheyenne Renner. Trey Birchfield into the final four with a win earlier tonight
Duncan Clemmer having a terrific week here in Rock Hill. He's into the Final Four. Ryan Windsor, number four player in the world, he's in. And now the winner of this matchup will join those other three. Grindersleeve trying to grab that other bag, can't do it, and now a chance for another big round here for Renner.
Now got to go in just to limit it to four.
And he does, so a three-point round followed up by a four-point round. And now 7-0 Cheyenne Renner.
Now, I think if my memory serves me correct, this game started similar. This game started similarly to the last one. The thing is, Eddie in the late first half and into the early second half of the game was just flipped a switch.
Yes. As soon as Cheyenne got to 10 points, because you mentioned she had gotten to double digits, and all of a sudden he went on that big run.
Right.
Yep. Right, I mean, right, literally right at the midway point. Bunched up there on the front side.
Don't get kicked. You want to just stay center. That's perfect. You'll take that. And now Cheyenne wants to lay behind. Best thing to do is right here. You let Eddie do the work. Oh, I don't love that, because now Eddie can just clean it up for points.
Yep. And can't do it. It just hangs on that front side lip.
Yeah, but like I said, I think that was risky by Cheyenne Renner, because what I thought she was going to do was lay behind, force an airmail attempt by Eddie Grindersleeve to have the same thing happen as before. He hits on top, they all fall, but then he trampolines off the back and you steal a point. We saw her do that early in the last game.
Both players seem to be locked in again this round. Grindersleeve answers, double four bagger wash, so still a 7-0 lead for Cheyenne Renner.
7-0.
So many stories that have come out of this sport. So many good people, hardworking people, and Cheyenne just one of the many laid off during the pandemic.
Oh, she goes no hesitation airmail. I didn't think she'd go immediately. Wow.
Grindersleeve just sneaks it in.
And she creates a lane for Grindersleeve to be more aggressive.
Nice shot. Cheyenne sneaks it in.
Now, can Eddie collect this bag for four?
Goes low, spins it, and spins it off the back of the board.
Wow, that is not how I envisioned that round being.
I thought he'd get at least one in.
Yeah, I thought for sure, hey, you go hard, slick up the middle. Yeah. At worst, you just go in and leave the bag sitting in front.
So instead of Grindersleeve, what, getting a potential tray of four, it ends up being plus one Renner. 8-0. So really, in essence, a five-point swing. Oh, now Cheyenne helps Eddie out a little bit.
And Eddie helps her right back. Can Eddie get all of these?
Oh, he gets two, and the other one just hangs on the back of the board.
So that's going to be a single point for Eddie Grindersleeve. He gets on the board.
Oh, man, it is hard right now, isn't it? This is a hard match.
It is.
I mean, he is working hard just to get that one point. 8-1. Nice bag right in front of the hole, and Cheyenne just goes right through it. Oh, interesting now. First two in for Cheyenne. Trying to sneak this one by.
In for two. Oh, and it just hangs out to the right.
Every time.
8-1. Is Eddie's mic on, or is he just another quiet player?
Yeah. I think the only time I've heard him say something is when Cheyenne said, good luck, he said, you too.
Yeah. I think I've heard him clear his throat, and that's about it. Third bag in. Grinder sleeve for the four bagger, and Cheyenne with the answer.
This is I feel like I'm watching deja vu. This is what we saw. Eddie Grindersleeve wasn't hot to start the game, and now all of a sudden, coming out middle part of this game, he starts to heat up and feels like he's never going to miss.
Just hanging in there, hoping for a mistake here by Cheyenne.
Go up, nope. Goes. Chooses to lay behind. She can stay skinny. Hard push.
Goes after it, gets them both. Big wow. Shot for Cheyenne Renner.
And those were the shots she was hitting all day earlier in the big games when she went undefeated through the winner's bracket. It was shots like these, the pushes and the collects.
Adds 2 points to make it a 10-1 lead.
And again, she's in double digits.
Yep. So 10-1 here in this game. It was, what, 10, about 10-4, 10-6 in the first game when Grindersleeve made his move.
Double four backer. These two are slinging it.
Yeah, I've never seen Eddie play any better than this. So consistent. That one might come back. It's kind of inching its way back just through the vibration of the board.
I think it'll go. Yep. Oh, that's such a hard bag because it now it has to be gone through. And now I think Cheyenne is best to actually lay perfectly behind if she can. No, she chooses to go through, and that works too.
Puts the pressure back on Grindersleeve, and he's able to knock it in. Another double four bagger. And it will stay a 9-point lead here for Cheyenne Renner, again trying to become the first female player here to advance into the pro singles final four. This would be another historic moment here in the sport of cornhole. Just a few weeks ago, as Trey mentioned earlier, we saw Cameron Belvin win a pro doubles event. First time a female player had done that at the pro shootout in Atlanta. So trying to keep it going.
Oh, and that's beautiful because it makes just go through a little bit more difficult.
Missed it.
Wow, that's going to be a 5-point round, 15-1.
15-1, Renner.
Well, we see history here in the sport of cornhole for the second time in what, just a month?
Yes. And she just doesn't even worry about trying to get around it. She just says, I'm just gonna be up the middle. That's all that matters.
Good shot there by Eddie to push him up.
And that'll go. That's beautiful. She bullied this bag out of the way.
She bullied it up all the way to that left-hand top corner. And takes them both.
Oh, my gosh.
Can Eddie grab this one at all?
He's not going for it.
And it's short. And now Cheyenne Renner, who gets 4 points, is just 2 points away. And Allison Peters knows what is on the line here in Rock Hill. 19-1
is 2 points away from history.
Oh, Eddie cannot make a mistake at all at this point. Third one in for Cheyenne. That one should go, you'd think.
Gotta be in.
It is short, and Cheyenne Ritter makes history again. This time in Rock Hill, South Carolina, the first ever female player to advance into an ACL Pro Final Four singles event.
Ladies and gentlemen, what you have seen from Cheyenne Ritter is the single greatest performance over a span of an entire week that we have ever seen in our sport. She is unbelievable, and it could not have happened to a better person. Cheyenne Ritter, history is made.
You are awesome.
Well, hugs and congratulations from everyone here in Rock Hill, all knowing history has been made.
What, Jeff, it's just, it's as someone that has been involved in the sport for so long and as someone that is so passionate about it, this for me is borderline an emotional win, because I'm seeing our sport evolve right here in front of us, and it's just, it's unbelievable, it's breathtaking, it's just truly amazing.
So the final four is complete. Duncan Klemmer, Trey Birchfield, Cheyenne Ritter, and Ryan Windsor. Your final four for the singles world championship here in Rock Hill. And Trey, I don't even know where to start with all the storylines in this one. I mean, Duncan Klemmer has come out of nowhere this week. Trey Birchfield, no surprise, number two player in the world. He's got a chance to be number one. Ryan Windsor, number four. He's still got a chance, right, for number one. And then Cheyenne Ritter makes history.
Jeff, I don't have the analysis for you. I mean, it's just, I just can't get over Cheyenne Ritter and how proud we should be. And you know what? Eddie Grindersleeve, you know, shout out. I hate that you were in that position to be, you know, have to go against Cheyenne like that. You threw your absolute butt off. But this day and this night belongs to Cheyenne Ritter.
Again, first ever female here in the ACL to advance into a pro singles final four. History made again here in Rock Hill. It's going to be a fantastic finish for the Pro Singles World Championship here in Rock Hill. Make sure you stay tuned this weekend here on ESPN and ESPN2. For Trey Ritter and our entire crew, I'm Jeff McCarriger. Thanks for watching, and good night here from the Palmetto State.